Ho, 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 give it up. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. I am here. It's your humble host. Can we spin up the background music a little? Kev, let's spin that up in the background there. How are we? How is everyone this Wednesday? Now, I just barely had time to tweet out, post that we're live. I want to double check and make sure. I'm looking in the chat. Do I see any number ones? Are we there? Are we looking nice? Looks like Demos and Discs is up and live, but I'm waiting for the Stocks Are Up or the number one. Fucking give it to me, please. Let's back out of the display here. Who doesn't miss the fabulous PS2? I see a lot of number ones. I'm really feeling that. We are taking your Skype calls. We're going to be playing some music. I've got demos, we've got discs, what's here? This is a PlayStation magazine, official US PlayStation magazine demo disc. I say we start there. Oh God, if I'm gonna scratch this, it's gonna be worthless. We've also got some classics, some PS1 games. Valkyrie Profile Slamaria, Profile 2. I want to pop that in later. I want to see what's on some of these demo discs first, though. So while we do that, we will head straight to the phones. See if the PS2 can still read DVDs. We are on Skype, as you would imagine. Let me go to the browser and see if the disc has popped up. Oh, there it is. God, what is on these memory cards? Tony Hawk Pro Skater, that's the new data. A lot of Guitar Hero, I see. Wow, long time to load. There's some Resident Evil something. What is that? Outbreak. Okay, alright. And what's this? Oh, Codebreaker. I was a cheater in my youth. So yeah, let's go back to the disc. Speaking of demos, last week on the show, I briefly mentioned interest in doing like a hardcore... I don't know how to phrase that. Hardcore music, retrospective. At least, San Diego hardcore music. Hardcore was a genre of music. I've got some demo tapes. I've got some really good stuff that's, like, probably, never been heard from people outside of Southern California. So it'd be cool to come in one weekend and do just a total music show, but I brought in a cassette tape of some really rare shit. This is San Diego Hardcore's finest, Forced Life. They were big, I'm sure, NFL fans here. What is this? It's just playing me a demo video. So maybe we'll hear a track off of this Forced Life. This is like legit photocopied and taped off of someone else's demo tape. This is the, reciting Verses of Agony. Yeah, this is great. There's a dedication even, because it was on my friend Terry, Nara, she went by Nara at some point. And it's signed by some band member that gave this to her. Memories, but let's see. Let's see if I can rig this little Walkman here to work. Until then, I want to go and play something. Not Game Breaker, not iNinja, not Castlevania, but oh, a little game called 13. This is a weird one. I like weird ones. Ryan, the good doctor, he's a weird one too. How are you, Ryan? Mr. Reed.
Hello?
Yes, an apple a day typically keeps you away, but here you are. What can I do you for?
Hey, what's going on, man?
How are you?
I'm good. I'm feeling good. I just got off work, and I got a unicorn espresso, and it was pretty terrible, and now I'm watching your great show.
You got one of those unicorn frappuccinos from good old Starbucks?
Oh, yeah, they're terrible. They taste like nothing.
Oh, it tastes like nothing? It's just, like, really pretty looking?
It's pretty looking, and they say it's mango flavored, but I swear it was
mango,
like, drinking
flavored.
Water.
Nothing like about no it flavor. Looked mango. It's like pink. It should be fucking strawberry flavored.
No, they said it was mango flavored.
I went to Starbucks, but I just got an iced coffee. I didn't go for a unicorn diabetes bomb. What do you call
it? Yeah, I just don't. This thing, I got a small, and it was $4.50.
Whoa!
Yeah,
the wrong
up.
Business.
Ooh, meow.
That wasn't the one I wanted. There we go. Now, Ryan, have you ever played 13? This is a game from a 2003 demo disc.
No, is this the David Duchovny game that's like all cel shaded?
It is all cel shaded, and I don't remember what I had to do with David Duchovny, but for some reason that sounds weirdly familiar. There was also that game like Killer 7, and I always got confused with this.
Yeah, no, me too. Like, those two are, like, both, like, heavily cel-shaded, and, like, it came out around the same time.
Yeah.
But,
ooh, Baywatch style.
I know nothing about this game other than, like, I think David Duchovny is the voice of the main character, who I think is number 13? I don't know.
Oh, maybe that's Mr. Duchovny, maybe, is the voice. Okay, all right. My favorite David Duchovny role was in Twin Peaks, where he cross-dressed. Here.
My favorite David Duchovny role is in Californication, where he fucks a lot.
He does fuck a lot. David Duchovny fucks.
He does.
I also like him. I take that back. My favorite role is in the episode of The X-Files, where the story is being told through a third person about agents Scully and Fox. Talk. And not a good time. They have David Duchovny make a noise, and he goes like, I'll do it into the mic here.
It's an interesting noise, and he goes like, whoop!
Like that. It's hilarious, Ryan, I know.
It's very funny.
Yeah, it's funny stuff. The guy says to him, it appears he's a mandroid, and he goes, whoop! Like that.
I have asthma.
Oh, someone's looking for me, hold on. Oh shit, okay. This guy's got an AK-47. There's no way I'm going out there.
That's fine.
I do want to open this drawer. Wow, got a throwing knife. I've got a throwing knife.
Throw it into his head.
I did.
Did you do that?
I did it.
Yay!
It's sticking out of his head and there's blood falling.
Hell yeah.
He looks kind of like Luke Cage.
Oh, I like that show.
Wow, there's a whole chopper. There's a lot of stuff going on here. But, all right. Well, Ryan, as I check out 13 and become more confused, you haven't called into the PPS in quite some time. What have you been up to? I know that a new Fast and Furious movie has been released.
Fate of the Furious did come out. It's probably, I would tie it for the second best Fast and the Furious movie of all time. Because nothing beats Tokyo Drift. Tokyo Drift is the quintessential movie. It's basically... Drift is if they made a live-action Persona movie.
Tokyo Drift is number one in your boat.
Tokyo Drift is above reproach. In fact, I think it's unfair to compare the rest of the Fast and the Furious movies to Tokyo Drift because Tokyo Drift is so good. So if we were to take that out of the equation, I would say that the new Fast and the Furious, Fate of the Furious, is probably ties with the best of
the
main
best.
Core franchise.
Dude, you heard it here first. Fast and the Furious, Fate of the Furious, Second best in the franchise.
Yeah, I suggest everyone to go see it. It makes more sense. Okay, I love the Fast and the Furious, much like the reason I think you love Metal Gear Solid.
Oh, wait. I thought we were... Hold on, back this up a second. I thought we were going to compare shitty movie franchises, like you were going to say Resident Evil.
I hope everyone's enjoying the live
broadcast. As far as the Mila Jovovich films.
Jovovich.
Let's take that back again. Mila Jovovich fandom is strong.
Don't fuck
with
it up. No, I think that it relates to your love of Metal Gear Solid.
Metal Gear Solid. Okay,
why.
Do tell.
Because, and from talking to you in the past, maybe I'm wrong, but I get the reason that you like Metal Gear Solid that I've heard in the past is that it's great story structure and the way that it calls back and it builds the world.
Oh, yeah.
Would you agree?
Oh, yeah.
And that's the reason I like the Fast and the Furious franchise, because it's the same thing.
It's the Toretto family. It's the world building. It's all encompassing across how many films now?
This is the Fate of the Furious is the 8th film.
Oh my god. Now, what about that really skinny girl who was, I think, Dom's sister? That was
Jordana Brewster. Yeah, Mia.
And she
Toretto.
Was married. She was married to
Brian O'Connor.
Yeah, well, what's the actor's name?
Paul Walker.
Yeah, but he is not in this film. Is she in this film?
No, they wrote their characters out of the movie entirely. At the end of the last movie, I don't know if you saw Furious 7, a great movie.
I did see Furious 7, actually, yeah, unfortunately.
Okay, yeah, so if you remember, it ends with Mia and Brian and their son Jack on a beach playing, and then Dom gets in his car and drives away, but then
Brian pulls up
in his car, and they have a race, and then Brian drives off into heaven. So,
I know, it's sad. It makes me cry. When I saw that, I like got a little tear. Dude, I teared up for Diesel. I felt bad for Vin Diesel. Like, it's weird. It's like, I know that was his friend, and I know that he really died in real life.
They were really good friends. They had done so many movies together. They were like,
well, what are the odds that this stupid fucking film franchise takes off and they make millions doing this dumb car chasing shit? I mean, you gotta bond with the people making that stuff with you.
Oh, especially, like, when that first movie came out, like, that's when Vin Diesel was doing a bunch of franchises, and he was like, I don't do sequels, I just make movies and I move on. So he was never expecting to see Paul Walker again. Then, you know, they did Fast and the Furious, that's number 4 together, and then 4, 5, 6, and then 7, and he tragically died during it, and it was really sad, and so, yeah.
Well... Dominic Toretto lives on, and we can learn from his life lessons. Does everything end? I mean, no spoilers, but is it all okay at the end of the Fate of the Furious? Or is the fate rest in good hands? Are we getting a 9th film?
I don't want to say any spoilers. I will just say that there is a 9th film.
Always open.
That is confirmed. 9 and 10 are confirmed.
Wow.
Now, the rumors, I don't know if you... Now, these aren't spoilers, but are we allowed to go into rumors? Can we go into the rumor mill?
Yeah, let's mill it over.
Okay, the two big, I mean, can you, before we do that, can you play the rumor mill opening?
Yeah, you need rumor mill theme, here you go. Let that build for a little bit, and then let me know what the rumor is. This guy, wow, with the fucking revolver from up high. I threw my,
Did you just get rid of your fucking
Yeah,
first
did you see that? I fucking threw the first aid, like, fuck, I don't need the heal. That was crazy. Oh, my grip.
All right.
Yeah, okay, go ahead. Rumor mill.
Two big rumors. Number one, we're going to space.
Oh, I heard that. I did hear that.
That makes me happy, but more than anything, what makes me even happier is the second rumor, that we might have the return of the best character in the Fast and the Furious franchise.
Uh-oh.
Han.
Han, the guy from Tokyo Drift.
Yeah, Han, played by Sun Kang.
Did he have a small... did he have a small cameo in The Fate of the Furious, the 7th film?
No, Fate of the Furious is the 8th film.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry.
The good way to remember that is that it's called The Fate of the Furious because F8.
Oh, F8. Fate. Okay. Well, what about the previous film? Now, I remember they called him up on... And he just had, like, a scene where he was on a cell phone, maybe, or something?
So, okay, so what happened is he was introduced in the third movie, Tokyo. Okay.
give us the full
history. For anyone who hasn't
seen
these, there's going to be a couple spoilers, but let me...
Yeah.
So in the third movie, The Fast and the Furious Tokyo Drift, we introduced the Han.
Okay.
His name is Han Solo because he's Korean.
Oh, fucking
so it's Seoul, like the capital South Korea.
Yeah, I got you.
Got it. He was actually introduced, of course, in Justin Lin's movie Better Luck Tomorrow, which is a great movie. You should all watch it.
Wait, this character is from a different franchise?
Yes. Well, not franchise. Justin Lin, who's the director of Fast and the Furious 3 through 6.
Oh, he's made other films in the same universe.
Well, he made a movie before he even made Fast and the Furious. He made it, like, I want to say around college or nothing. But it's called Better Luck Tomorrow. It's a really good movie based on a true story about kids in Orange County who, like, were, you know, they were, like, honor students who got bored, so they got into crime.
The honor students returned to class and became bullies.
Correct.
Okay.
It's a really good movie, and you should, I don't know if you've seen it, but people out there, you should look up Better Luck Tomorrow. I know Frank will go on and on about how it's one of his
movies. Frank's a big old film buff, if you didn't know.
Frank's a film fan.
I just shot the cult leader from Heaven's Gate in the head. Oh no, that's a beanie, that's not silver hair. I thought
is that Marshall Applewood? I thought
just assassinated Marshall Outwood, Applewood, yeah.
Apple White, I think.
Apple White, that's what it was. God.
That happened in San Diego, didn't it?
No, it was like north, a little north of San Diego. I love my cult leaders. I wish it was San Diego County. I think it was like technically like, God, I want to say like, I don't want to say anything because I don't fucking know.
All right. Somebody look that up. Han was introduced in Fast and the Furious Tokyo Drift. And he's, you know, Sean Boswell, who moves to Japan after he gets in all that trouble. He meets Han, and Han tests his character. And Han dies in Tokyo Drift.
Say it ain't so.
They call it soy juice. You can't do that.
Soy jism.
And so, you know, it was a great movie. It's great sad. Very sad ending, you know, but it taught Sean, you know, truth about life.
Okay.
And then come out a couple years later, we get Fast and the Furious, and lo and behold, who's in the beginning? Han. Wait a second, Han's dead. Uh-oh. 4, 5, and 6 happened before 3. This movie series has a time loop.
Oh, really? So there is a point where Han will die.
Yeah, Han dies in 3, but he's in 4, 5, and 6. So he's in a little bit beat part in 4. He's a major part in 5 and a major part in 6. And what's funny is at the end of every movie, and you know, they're, you know, like in the first one after the opening scene, he goes, "Where are you going?" It's like, "I think Tokyo might be fun."
Oh,
so
he's
think,
on
okay,
his way.
Okay, this was a little scene before that. But then he's in 5. And
so
in 5, of course.
3 still is the end. It takes place in the future. Hasn't happened yet.
Well, it has happened now because, so, and you'll love this. Let me explain.
Okay, retcon this for me, please.
So 5 happens. And that's, of course, that's the one with the big heist where they're stealing the safe and dragging it through Rio de Janeiro.
Oh, yeah.
And that's where he meets his love, Giselle. Giselle was, of course, introduced in 4 as one of Braga's associates. She's an ex-Mossad who helps him run drugs. But she turns good to work with the family.
Of course.
Of course. And so...
Rosette.
They meet in 5. Then 6 happens. They're enjoying their $10 million. They love it. They love life. And
gotta
then,
love
course, it. At the end of 6, when fighting the dastardly Owen Shaw, played by Luke Evans,
Giselle dies.
She to save Han's life, she jumps off the back of that car that's being dragged by the airplane while it's trying to take off, and she shoots the guy while falling back into darkness. It's very sad.
Sacrifice,
and so at the
dude.
End of the movie, yeah, at the end of the movie, Han's very sad, and he's like, "I think I'm finally going to go to Tokyo." And he does.
Finally.
He goes to Tokyo, and that's when 3 happens. But... they put a spoiler, or not, I'm sorry, not a spoiler. What's it, what's the word I'm looking for? When it's after the credits, what's that called?
Oh, what do they call that?
Stinger. A
stinger.
Stinger,
yeah, stinger. Like
so
Sting,
stinger,
my favorite wrestler.
Yeah, Stinger!
I've never played this Castlevania game. This is fucking...
Which Castlevania game is this?
This is, I didn't see what it said. What'd it say?
Lament of Innocence?
Yeah,
I've never played that one either.
Lament
what's your
of
favorite
Innocence?
Castlevania?
Wait, did it just fucking back me out? Oh, I gotta say, what was the Kojima one?
Oh, Lords of Shadow?
Yeah, Lords of Shadow by far, I think, is my favorite Castlevania. I mean, Symphony of the Night is fucking great, don't get me wrong. In Castlevania,
did you ever play any of the,
2 is my favorite, as far as, like, retro.
Did you ever play any of the Game Boy Advance ones?
Yeah, I did play, or you know what? I played a 3DS one that bridged the two Lords of Shadow.
There's some really good, I don't know if you're big on going back and playing like handhelds, but there were some really good, that's when the whole Metroidvania craze was like made.
Yeah, dude, I love that word.
It is a fun word to say.
Fun word
my
to
favorite
say.
Of those is Harmony of Dissonance was a really, really good
oh,
one.
Yeah.
I remember playing that a lot in like high school.
I remember hearing the name of Harmony of Dissonance. Don't
walk that's away from me. That's a Just Belmont, spelled J-U-S-T-E.
Just Belmont.
Just Belmont. Hey, it's Just Belmont.
Enough fucking Belmont. The one, the 3DS one that bridged the two Lords of Shadows was cool because I think there were like up to four, or no, I think there were three different Belmonts you could play as.
Oh shit, that's cool.
But one was also like a turned Dracula. It was interesting. It was good.
Did you ever play the second Lords of Shadow? Was that open
yeah.
world like everyone was talking about?
I played, you know what? I played most of the, I keep timing out this demo because I'm talking over the fucking thing. But yeah, the Lords of Shadow 2 was not as good as 1. I mean, 1 had Kojima teamed up on it. And
oh, was he not involved in the second one?
No, not at all. And it kind of like, it built on the story of the first one, but not at all how the storytelling of the first one worked. This first one is like linear.
Yeah, you're fighting Satan, right?
No, not really.
I thought Satan.
I can't think. No, there was a bunch of different like sub bosses and stuff, mini bosses. There was some good DLC for it too, where you could play chess with a vampire
Ooh, I like
girl
chess.
Named Laura. Laura.
Laura.
It was fun, man.
You must think I'm garbage.
But the second one was just like not. It was like, all right, here's like a shitty sequel. It was. I got the story done, and I was like, all right, enough of that. You got to play as the same character and then a new character, and I think that was a big thing. That was the big draw, was you got to play as the new character was one of the fucking Belmonts that gets turned into a vampire, and he's all pissed off. Some shit like that. I don't know. Who knows the stories of these games? You know?
Well, you know, the story I do know is at the end of Tokyo or Fast and the Furious
God
6
damn it. Yeah.
is that so they re-show the scene where Han dies in Tokyo Drift because he's drifting away from the Drift King Takashi, who's really mad because his uncle played by but his uncle's a Yakuza
yeah.
and they get away. So
oh, no.
all of a sudden he gets crashed and he dies, and then that's how he died in the third movie. Well, guess
Bummer.
What? They retconned it. Now they showed he didn't just get in a car accident.
Oh, he didn't.
He was murdered by Owen Shaw's brother Decker Shaw, played by Jason Statham.
So
that's how they got
so
Jason
it all
Statham
ties in. Statham
yeah.
Statham's fucking responsible. The goddamn professional is always busting balls and killing Asian drifters.
So yeah. So the
now here's
is
the thing. Here's the thing.
Back
you got to stop with the fucking. I have to hang up if you keep. Are you going to keep going with the story of Fast and the Furious?
No, you know, I originally called in to talk about Persona, but you brought up Fast and the Furious.
I know, but it's like I led you down a path and now you can't stop.
You really, like,
God.
Honestly, at this point, you should probably hang up because now I really want to talk about the deep intricacies about
No more drifting.
Amnesia.
No more drifting, no more none of that. Let's go right. quick because the calls are stacking.
I just want to know.
What about Persona? Yeah.
It just came out. You haven't really talked about it. I don't know if you're a big Persona boy,
no.
but I finished Persona 5. Did you play it?
No. New Chie, old Chie, don't care. Haven't played any of the Persona games. You know, I hear this one's good, but, like, there's just too much. Like, after I get done with Zelda, I want to try out this Nier Automata.
I still need to play that.
Gotta play that. I hear good. What? Oh, the fucking analog stick doesn't even do anything. Okay. I still gotta try out, God,
have you played Horizon?
About Horizon Zero Dawn.
God, that game's so good, dude. You gotta play Horizon.
Yeah, so, like, when am I gonna get to Persona?
I don't know.
I got no...
Free time.
Love for the franchise, though. I got no history with it, so I'm...
Oh, that's fair.
I'm not looking to pick up a brand new thing, you know?
Yeah, no. I mean, if you don't have love for Persona, I wouldn't play it. Like,
and I got, but I got a love for Nier too, and that's an existing franchise.
I put 115 hours into Persona 5. That's Jesus. Only because I like it. If you don't like it, you're not gonna.
Well,
do
I don't
that.
Know. That's my problem. Is I've only heard good things about this game, but I've never played them. Persona 4 Golden seemed like the one to get on Vita, but never got. That was something I always planned on trying to check out, and never came to fruition. Fishman's going down. I'm fucking just knifing him out. I got throwing stars, baby. But
do you have a cross? Even
I don't know if I have a cross yet. I think I was just doing some throw star action. Oh, I found like a whip move. Whoa.
That's cool.
Oh, I can do like a tornado whip move. I keep accidentally using fucking potions. Because the right analog stick is just like to bring up your menu, and it's so easily hit.
Oh. God, PS2 games have the worst fucking controls.
Oh, yeah. Remember Summoner?
I'm playing. I'm big on like achievement or trophy getting, so I've been playing a lot of old PS2 games. Like right now, I'm playing Mark of Kree. Do you ever remember that game?
Ooh, Mark of Kree. No.
It's a cool game I had as a kid. Like, I never finished it, so I'm getting it now. It was, like, based on, like, Polynesian fighting. It's really fun, but the controls suck.
Yeah, dealing with the controls in some of these old games is, like, half the appeal. You're just trying to overcome and master how shitty the controls are half the time. Like, when I get stuck at a level, it's not because I don't know what to do. It's because, like, the camera moves and I walk right off. That's why I could never play the God of War franchise. I just fucking can't do it.
I
don't know if you ever had trouble with those games, but...
I only ever played the first God of War because I tried playing the second one and I was just like... By the time... I didn't play when it first came out. Like, I waited and tried to play it as one of those remastered games and it was just like, I can't fucking play this because I can't fucking make anything work.
Nothing's working. Oh my god, boulders. I'm in a room with falling rocks. It's a trap type of room. This is a dirty trick, a dirty Dracula trick.
Are you playing Conception 4 again?
I know, it's like I'm Conception 4.
Are you a hacker?
Or Decep-
yeah,
fuck.
Deception.
What was
you must think I'm garbage. Whoops.
What was no. that game where you were the devil princess and you had to trap
That's
room?
The Deception franchise, which I
oh,
love.
Sorry.
I'm a big fan of Deception. That's the only game I still play on my Vita.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, fuck. Oh. I can't get out. Maybe there's someone we have to hurt in here.
Is there a secret devil you have to get?
A secret devil that I gotta kill in here? I don't know. It's so they'll stop dropping rocks. I've used all the potions I have, so now I can't accidentally use anymore. This is one of those times where I'm locked in a room, but I don't really know what to do.
You have to escape. This is one of those escape. This started the escape the room craze.
Oh yeah, I'm doing a Zelda themed room escape. I need 17 what? Friends.
When is that?
Oh, look, you've got to break the boulders. I was being facetious, you dick.
Oh no, I was like, I want to do. I've
Dude,
always
there's like tons of those.
So they were doing a Resident Evil 7 special one in Portland. And I kept talking to my friends. I was like, all right, we have to get tickets ahead of time. I want to do this. Like, I was in all in, and my friends kept dragging their feet, and now it's over, and it's like I fucking missed out on it.
Yeah,
I've
you know,
always wanted to try one of those escape rooms.
I just feel like the whole time I would be in it, I wouldn't be able to enjoy it.
Why not?
Because I would be, like, picking it apart as, like, I could do this better. I could run this better. I don't know, and the thing is too, like, escape rooms, I don't know, they kind of seem like a fucking weird, like, gimmick, like, let's make easy money. It just seems like, fuck, if you can get the license to something, although I doubt these people get the license to Resident Evil in fucking Portland to really run some shit, like,
well,
officially.
It was put on by, you know, I Am 8-Bit?
Yeah.
It was put on by them, and they did it across the country.
Yeah, see, I feel like this company, I Am 8-Bit, doing shit like this, I'm insanely jealous. Like, why didn't I fucking think of this first?
They did one at PAX. It wasn't an escape room thing. It was more like a big... They threw a big party for Dishonored 2. I went there with Jared Thorban. You know Jared.
Yeah.
And so it was like this big mystery of, like, while you're there, you know, try this game, blah, blah, blah. And then there was this whole, like, kind of escape room style, like, scavenger hunt mystery thing where you had to do... you know, go here, find out this clue about the game, go and talk to this person, give them the code phrase and get a thing.
That's cool.
And I was having a lot of fun. We were doing it together, and he was more just watching me run around like a fucking child. But I got to this point where it's like, I need a thing, and it's like, nope, sorry, we're all out. And it's like, what? Yeah, we only made 10 of them. It's like, dog, there's like 1,000 people here. It's like, well, we didn't think about that.
Yeah. Go figure, a poorly ran alternate reality thing. Yeah, back in the day, dude, when Lost was still on TV, they did a bunch of fucking cool ones. But that even happened with the Lost shit. Like, sometimes it wouldn't pan out because it just wasn't ran well.
Fuck, did I ever tell you I won one of those Lost things, and then I forgot that I had signed up with it with a different email because I didn't want to get spam, so I never got my prize.
Oh, you fucked up.
There was this big thing, and the prize was they gave it to 108 people. It was a bottle, like a, you know, washed up at sea with USB drive in it with like the first 10 minutes of the finale.
Oh, that's sick, dude. What a collector's item. I still got all my vitamin water from Dharma, but that's some real shit.
And I fucking was like, oh, this will be fun. And I signed up with a bunch of different emails because I wanted a bunch of different, you know, tries at it. That's actually what it was. I signed up like a bunch of multiple times. And I won on one of the emails that I just never fucking checked. And I was like, oh, I remember about that. And
that's what you get for being a cheat.
My other email, and I did, and it was like, hey, you won. Hey, you have 12 days to send us your address. You have 11 days. You have 10 days. I was like, fuck.
Dude, you put so many emails in that you don't deserve to win because of the cheat aspect.
I did like three.
Well, that's too many, buddy. I mean, I was there with my one email, and you went ahead and thought it wise to fake and lie, and the universe smited you.
I got, yeah. You got I've learned my lesson.
Well, I don't,
I have no longer.
This guy's health is going down into the yellow. I need to move, because he's getting, ooh. I've got one more bar to take him down. I hope.
What
I
is he?
He's a golem. This is your standard rock creature brought to life through archaic magic.
Oh.
What did happen?
What did happen?
What did happen?
Can it be done? How come we let there be golems?
I don't know. I think that's the end of the demo. Maybe it was a timed thing? Who knows?
Fucking demo discs are weird.
Well, hey, Ryan.
Good chism.
Thank you for calling in. And thank you
for... Thank you for having.
Thank you for the Fast and the Furious, Fate of the Furious recap and wrap up. Thank you for the Persona chat. And I hope to be seeing you soon. Are you coming to any cons in the future?
Looks like I will be coming. I think I'm going to be coming down for Anime Expo, even though I'm not a big anime fan.
Ooh.
Just to, you know, hang out. So I might see you at the end of June.
I'll be at AX. We definitely got a panel for one of those Anime Expo days. I'm also going to RTX, so it is official. Tickets are booked. I'm coming back to Austin, Texas. Hip hip hooray.
Woo!
Thank you, Ryan. We sure do love you. We'll see you next time. Kisses.
Bye, 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 bye.
Big kisses from Dr. Rai Rai. This is a leftover crack song. We'll be back. No. Sorry, this is a choking victim song.
My precious blood.
Pay attention, this is important.
It's brought to you by PlayStation 2. Always on the cutting edge of pop culture, PlayStation 2 pulls out all the stops at the first ever Wizard World Texas.
Yeah.
The three-day convention will encompass comic books, movies, television, toys, animation, and the latest from PlayStation 2. 989 Sports and PlayStation tour the nation as part of the U.S. Army All-American National Tour.
Hell yeah, gotta
support
the troops!
In search of the best high school football players in the nation. School-wide tournaments will determine two lucky winners who will ultimately get a trip to the big all-star game to battle it out on NCAA Game Breaker 2004.
Yeah.
Visit the website for further details.
Okay, what's the site?
The Suzuki Heisman Tour is bringing
that
the
is
Heisman
a
Trophy
photo.
To schools with serious award contenders. In addition to taking a
Excuse
photo
me, I was
of the
running
most
around
famous
earlier
trophy in college
song.
Sports, students can also sample products, win t-shirts, pick up free issues of ESPN the magazine,
Suzuki.
And test their skills on NCAA Game Breaker
Sukiyaki,
2004
huh?
from 989 Sports. Check out the schedule and see if it's coming to a college near you. Hey basketball fans, vote for your favorite
DeGen.
NBA All-Star in NBA
DeGen.
Arenas
Yo.
And have a chance to win a PlayStation.
Yo, what's up? There's an ad for NBA 2004 going on right now in the background, but you're on with me. PPS, baby. Woohoo!
Yeah, how's it going?
This is about how it's going. This'll sum it up right now.
Ooh, yeah. Go in your room! Get in your room and be quiet!
So, are you in your room?
Yep, right now.
Is it quiet right now? Am I the only thing on?
It's 5 in the morning, so
oh,
yeah.
Fife!
Asleep.
Is that like a flute, a fife?
What?
Anyway, 5 in the morning. Yeah. Let's check out Eddie Murphy in the brand new feature coming soon, Haunted Mansion. Ooh, I bet you're scary. Or scared, rather. Wow, this is a... behind the scenes of the film featuring the Disneyland attraction. Look at that's Disneyland itself. Anyway, I'm just gonna let this play out. How the hell are you? Am I pronouncing that right, DJan?
It's pronounced Dayan. Dayan. But you can really go either way. Doesn't really matter.
All right. I'm gonna go with it that way. Yeah, I'll go that way. Day on. I want to be proper. I want to be a correct broadcaster. There's Eddie. I do a Eddie impression. You want to hear my Eddie?
Sure.
Okay, here it is.
That's it.
You must think I'm garbage.
It's not much, but you hear it there. It's a little bit there. Shouts out. I mean, recently departed. Charlie Murphy. No laughing matter. What the fuck? Very funny comedian. Died just this last week. Sad news. Didn't mean to bring the show down. Fuck. Dayan?
Yeah.
Dayan.
Yeah.
I like that. So now you're here with me. We're learning all about what goes on in the Haunted Mansion. Have you ever been to the... the Disney theme parks. Have you ever visited a Disney attraction?
Nope.
You're not missing much. Nope. And you know what? Frankly, Disney has enough fucking money, so, you know, don't spend any there.
I'm not really a fan of theme parks, but I guess if I had the chance, I would probably go.
It's a weird thing. That's like a very American family vacation. You gotta take the kids to the theme park. You gotta take them to Disneyland. You gotta take them. And it's like, for whatever reason, it's LA and Florida. I guess there's roller coaster, Busch Gardens, stuff like that. People like those kind of things. I get that over a regular theme park. I don't know. Rocco and everyone talking about the Star Wars Land stuff kind of got me excited. For whatever that is. An experience kind of sounds cool. I mean, here I am trashing escape rooms, but the Star Wars experience may be well enjoyed by me. I don't know. But Dayan, I know that it's dedication that brings you to me. 5 in the morning, you're still on with me. Man.
Mona
May
is our costume designer. Now Mona has a
new my hat's off to you. And I wore this, speaking of hats, I wore Kip's hat on the podcast like 2 weeks ago, and everyone's asking me on Twitter where to get it. I will forward you if you do ask me where Kip's hat is sold, and you can get one yourself. Just tweet me. But that's not what you wanted to talk about, Dehan.
No, I mean, like,
fucking
I'm
hats.
Currently, like, yeah.
What do you...
I'm currently working on my, like, final project for school.
Okay, I can dig it.
It's like, it's like a, I usually work as a graphic designer, but right now I'm doing, like, a video essay on Kojima.
Ooh.
And sort of his life story. So, like...
A video, you know what, there's a... I like video essays are a new format that I've found love for on
yeah.
YouTube. And surprisingly, they were Metal Gear related, but cool project, man.
Yeah, thanks. Have you watched like a recent boom on YouTube where all those like cinema video essays about like old classic movies and stuff? Like there's a couple of really quality channels that do these.
Really? No, I have not. I've checked
like,
out
I don't know.
these ones that go into like historical footage of like real world events and how they tie into the story of Metal Gear. The Future Sound Productions. I'll give them a shout out. Shouts out Future Sound Productions.
Cool.
On YouTube, they do these video essays, basic. All kind of summing up Metal Gear 5, but it goes way back, obviously. But
I found their channel yesterday while researching some stuff about Kojima, like
okay.
some videos about what was the true will of the boss and like stuff like that. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah,
it's a great channel. Are you gonna put yours up after you? I know you're doing this for school, but do you think you'll put this up online for people to see?
Yeah. Yeah. Of course.
Okay.
I mean,
that'd be. Hey, tweet it to me, man, because it's just based on Kojima and his career as a game developer.
Well, the title is Stronger Than Metal. It sort of like signifies the fact that Kojima has been talking for years now that he didn't really like want to make 5 Metal Gear games. He always said like this is my last one.
Yeah.
But Konami and I mean it's not just Konami, but the fandom itself always like pushed him to make another one, to continue the story, continue the lore.
Yeah.
He was always like he was talking like he wanted to do a family game, like a game that would appeal to families and stuff. He never got to make that, and
that's
I mean
so
now
weird.
It's doing Death Stranding, so. The title is supposed to like signify this he isn't just the Metal Gear guy, he's like an original creator who still has some tricks up his sleeve, like I mean Norman Reedus, Mads Mikkelsen, Toro all in one game. I mean that's something special.
Yeah, he's the only one who's like surpassed this. Kind of game developer persona and turned into like a almost celebrity Hollywood kind of icon where he's got these like real world actors, like we're talking about real actors who are about to appear in this game. We've like never had that before, maybe a little bit with stuff before. I remember like the first time I saw it was just fucking weird, if anyone remembers Onimusha 3. And they had Jean Renault in it. Do you remember that?
I remember. I never played it, but I don't
it was
know.
Like
the
it
answer.
Was like his face, and I was like, "What the fuck?" I mean, aside from movie tie-in games, like we're getting this director working with popular actors from popular TV shows and films, and like everyone has built him up into such a celebrity that yeah, he can't go make the little family game. I mean, he can when he gets his fuck you money and. You know, maybe starting his own studio now, getting out from under Konami, he'll get there. And you know, we saw stuff like that from I remember David Jaffe. You know, he made a lot of big games. He made all the Twisted Metal stuff, and then he wanted to just do an indie studio, make something small, and he did Calling All Cars. That was a PS3 game that was like a network download. God, that was such a fun game, and that was just I think. That story actually played out where he had to make these big things, but then he always wanted to make this small kind of little just fun game, and he did, and he got that chance to. So interesting, man. Well, how far along are you into the project? When's this fucker due?
Don't.
Well, the deadline is in 1 week, so I mean, right now, yeah.
Time's
right
wasted.
Now, like 70% complete. Like I have this bad habit of always doing all my stuff like at the last second. So currently, I'm waiting for
procrastinator. I hear you.
Yeah,
I've never
currently
played
I'm waiting
this
for some voiceover.
Bullshit.
Yeah.
You ever play X2 or what am I even doing? That's pause. Can they not jump? I guess not. Huh. All right. Anyway, sorry, dude. I didn't mean to halt your speaking. Go ahead.
No, I mean I was just saying you're right about Kojima and the whole like he. And like people don't really think about it that much, but he was kind of this one-hit wonder. I mean, Snatcher and Policonauts, like they were hits. But the thing is, Snatcher, as far as I know, like it was officially released in Japan and got for the West, and it was quite popular. But things like Policonauts never really made it officially to the West. So then they could never like garner real communities and such.
No.
So when someone says Kojima, you don't really think about Snatcher or Policonauts. It's always Metal Gear or something.
Yeah,
like,
that's what he's most known for. And I'm sure a lot of his fans are not there for the original Metal Gears, like the Nintendo ones.
Yeah.
You know, self-admittedly, I played Metal Gear Solid first, because when Metal Gear and Metal Gear 2 Solid Snake were out on NES, that was the only one that came, those came to the US.
Yeah.
Like, I knew friends that had them, but I was at an age when I had my NES where I was really, like, I didn't understand game theory, and I just did not fucking play games well. I'm gonna put a different PlayStation Magazine demo disc in here. As
remarkable thing about Kojima himself is that he was kind of this one-hit wonder. He had other projects, but he was always this kind of one-hit wonder with Metal Gear.
Yeah.
And now he's not even allowed to make Metal Gear anymore.
No,
people,
that's true.
No. Like follow him actively, he also like gets Hollywood great actors to like star in his new games. So Kojima is one of the few people who really rose above the legend, you know, like Big Boss and all that stuff.
Dude, speaking of the fucking man, I just put in this demo disc and there's a fucking interview, meet the creator of Metal Gear Solid right now for you, Dejan. Dayan, it's time to drop into Peace Walker, baby. No, this is Metal Gear 3, actually. So cool, man. He's unlike any fucking other person out there. And shouts out to the big names that you know by heart, like Cliff and, you know, Gabe Newell and fuck, I mean, I could name 20 guys. It would take me about an hour and a half. And some women. Don't forget the ladies. But the guy who stands above them all is our boy Hideo. That's why I like jokingly refer to him as this god-level entertainment. Because, like, above all other forms of entertainment, I like video games the most. Like, music's pretty high up there. But movies, music, video games has movies and music, and you fucking control it. I don't know. Maybe I go with video games top of the pyramid. And the number one guy who makes the best video games is that motherfucker on the screen. That was the wrong noise. There we go. So, yeah, man. My love for him is rivaled only by you, Dejan. Why do I do the fucking I throw an extra little kitty cat meow on it. Now I need the meow, and I don't have it. So, I wish you luck. You got 1 week. I'm going to tell you to turn the show off right now, and you got to get back to work. Well, wait, watch this. Yeah. This might be research right now. All right.
So, yeah.
All right, go. Let's go out. Let me know what was your favorite of the Metal Gears. What's your favorite one?
Oh, that's really a tough question. I
real
mean,
tough. But I'm gonna count you down right now. I need to hear it. What is it?
Favorite Metal Gear game would be. I mean, some people would say controversially, but it has to be Phantom Pain.
Okay, so, Phantom Pain. He said it. I'm hanging up. Goodbye, Dejan.
Yeah. Bye.
We sure do love you. We'll see you next time. Looks like Leo DiCaprio there. Concept art. Look at these young. Is that a young Yoji Shinkawa and a young. I don't know. I forget everyone's name here. Who's speaking too? I'm curious. The narrator in English.
The POV, an objective bird's eye view to create tension and suspense.
Oh, this sounds like just some fucking guy that works at.
Hideo Kojima has become known for blending the cinematic technique with
the
latest gaming technology
to
create new levels of shared personal gaming experiences.
Shaking.
Back when I started in the industry, people said games and film were like water and oil, that they'd never mix. But that's changed. We now have a common language.
Chocolate peanut butter situation.
Video games, film, music, everything has become so digital. And I think there will be a lot of blending going on. You'll see totally new discoveries sprouting out from the fusion.
That's what I was just talking about. The PPS is the blend.
Eventually,
we got games,
maybe even the word
music.
Game might be gone.
We got swear words.
I don't think video games have reached that status yet. Film, movies, and novels, the good ones, in addition to entertaining people, they have positive effects.
Tell me, senpai.
And I don't think video games have that effect yet.
Not
so
yet.
Hopefully in the future,
wait till you
there
make
will be
Metal
video
Gear
games
5.
Out there that have this positive effect on people's lives, just like movies and novels.
This guy's gonna revolutionize.
Sure,
he doesn't even
happens,
know.
Hideo Kojima will be at the front of the line having a positive effect on people. He shares his secret for worldwide success.
Video games are things that people play with, people use.
Hey, Scratch Man.
Yo, what's up?
Hey, video games are things that people play with, they use.
I hope everyone's enjoying
the as far as I know.
Is that something you'd agree with?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. He's dressed like fucking Steve Jobs. Hold on a sec. I just realized he's dressed like Steve Jobs. He's wearing a black turtleneck and glasses.
He's got similar glasses too, yeah.
Yeah, that's weird. Oh, he's eating that snake, dude. It's so fucking good. And don't
forget to check out the latest. I love just the little like hand motion.
I'm very content that I don't have to play any new video games. Because the old ones, why not keep going back and playing them? They fucking look good. That game looks good. That's PS2.
You know, I'm kind of running into that same brick wall myself.
Fuck it, man. Fuck spending money on the new shit and the season pass and the digital downloads and every... fuck it.
Yep. Just go back to Mom's place and be like, yo, Mom, I need my old video
game, all they're
please.
Doing is remaking the HD remasters and shit, too. Although, you know what? It's kind of cool how convenient it would be to play, like, Final Fantasy 12 again on PS4 when that comes out. That's kind of neat.
Yeah, that'd be really cool.
Kind of into that. Let's go back to the main menu. Well, anyway, Scratch Man.
I hope everyone's enjoying the live broadcast.
How are you today? How the hell are you, buddy?
Life is good, Garrett.
Life is good, okay. Catch me up on what you've been doing. Now, we've gotten updates from you in the past.
Yes.
Update us once more, please.
Well, actually, as like kind of a current update, I'm actually in the middle of a test right now. It's kind of similar to the last caller. He's in the middle of his final. I'm in the middle of one of those online course tests, so, you know, I got to turn it in by midnight or else, you know, I get a zero. Yeah, that
ooh,
whole thing.
Don't, a big old zero on your permanent record?
Yeah.
Fuck that.
I think some of these questions, I saw some of these questions, and I realized as I'm doing this quiz, I'm like, you know, Garrett might actually know the answers to some of these questions. So,
yeah.
Would you be interested in helping me?
I would very much be interested in helping you, yeah.
Alright, let's do it. All right.
Okay. But I want you, listen, Scratchman.
What's up?
I want you to just close your eyes when you're receiving these answers, and I want you to imagine that God is talking to you.
Lead me, Lord.
So I want you to ask the question in the form of a prayer. You understand?
I understand. Oh, okay. Lord.
Okay,
holiest of holies, okay. Man above.
Okay, ease up on, not too sappy.
Right.
Okay.
So, Lord.
Yes.
I need an answer to a question.
Yes, my son.
I need to know what Frank Yeager's code name is.
Oh, my child. A question as this shall be answered in due time. Frank Yeager's code name? This is a test for fucking school? Sorry, I swear up here. I make the rules, and I get to swear all I want. Now, okay, Frank Yeager's code name. Gray Fox. Is Gray Fox the answer?
It looks like I'm hitting the little check button right now. There's check. A check and an X. It's like... No,
and what are the four, what are the, is this multiple choice four questions?
No, this is right in.
Right
there's,
in.
It's got
okay.
The little dashes and the spaces. It's like, yeah, you
I think it's Gray Fox, I do believe.
Alright, I'm typing that.
I am the all-knowing Lord, but I am not, well, okay, I'm the omnipotent Lord, not the all-knowing Lord.
You have delivered unto me the correct answer. Okay.
Fuck yeah, buddy. That's right. One for us. One for the good guys.
Yep. All right. Question number two.
Shoot.
I need to know, Lord, what limbs does Kazuhira Miller lose in Metal Gear Solid, The Phantom Pain?
What the fuck? Joshua Pfeiffer, San Francisco, California. I don't know what I just found on this disc. This guy's dressed like a... He's... He was dressed like a militant anti-fa.
I've seen it right now on the stream.
Okay.
Yeah, he looks like...
okay, listen. So what did Kazuhiko Miller lose?
What limbs does Kazuhiko Miller lose?
One arm, one leg.
Yes.
I believe it was the left.
Now take the first player.
No, it was the left, maybe. Anyway. Ooh.
Looks like that's correct.
Looks like Xena. Okay, what's the third question? Is this the final question? I don't have all day. We've got a lot of clouds that we have to clean.
Yeah, this question's a little weird, though. It's oddly specific.
We have Charlie Murphy performing at 10:30 tonight, 2-drink minimum. It's going to be fucking awesome. He's going to make us all... He's going to kill us. He's going to kill. Get it? Get it? He's going to do a comedy show, and he's going to kill in heaven.
Make a lot of extra money doing this.
Going to straight up slay.
No.
Right, so this question...
People that slay go to hell. Anyway, next question.
And if you want, you can even...
This question...
This guy's
again,
still talking
a little
about
specific.
EverQuest. Uh-huh. Go ahead. Yeah.
What is Sean Chatfield's birthday?
Oh, fuck. Sean Virtual Boy Chatfield. His birthday is... Can I look at my... Can I use my divine powers to bring up the knowledge I seek upon Wi-Fi and calendar?
I mean, if that's what's required of you. I mean, I figured, you need God.
God had peppers and salami for lunch, so it's a bit gassy. I don't know if I can search S. He spells it that stupid way. S-H-A-W.
Spells it the unholy way.
Yeah. Oh yeah, fuck yeah, dude. Okay, thou hast to be celebrating Sean's birthday upon June 16th, my fair child.
June 16th. Is there
yes.
A year? I see like four little empty dashes right here.
Oh, shit. Wait, what is this? Am I don't think I should be helping you with this. I think this is some type of ploy. I think you're using me for something against my will.
I swear, Lord, there is no ploy here. I come to you as a meager beggar.
Alright, I don't know what fucking...
Seeking only knowledge.
It's like 80-something. Six or five, fucking four. 84, I say.
1980.
Scooby-Doo Mystery Mayhem. What's Rabbit King?
That's correct.
It is?
June 16th, 1984.
Oh, buddy. We did it.
Right. Yeah.
You and me both did it together. Wow, that's a weird... Bujangji. Bujangji.
Wait, it looks like there's one more question.
Watch. Oh, one more?
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
Oh, this one seems pretty easy. Where is a boob?
We can't show nipples on Twitch. It's against Twitch policy to show nipples.
That's understandable.
Oh, wait a minute. Hold on.
I guess just kind of...
Hold on. Scratch man. Human nipples, but hold on a sec. Just stay right there. One sec. Okay, Scratch Man, the answer you seek is here. Thank you. Good night.
That's it for Scratch Man, and Rabbit King's up next. But first...
May I speak?
Yeah, that's the wrong number.
May I ask who this is? Because I received this number from someone who gave it to me earlier to contact somebody I was looking for. Sir?
Yeah, I don't understand what you said.
I said, come on, sir. I said that I had this number, and I was wondering who you were.
I'm the person that has the number.
Is your name Bill, or William?
No.
My name isn't either. But you can suck my dick, in hell, you pussy. I don't mean that, but really I do. So fuck. Really I do. So fuck.
Order in the court! I said order in the court now!
Before this court passes judgment, will the four defendants please rise and approach the bench?
Trust me, guys, it's all under control. The judge is my uncle. He'll take the insanity plea. Oh yeah, don't forget my retainer balance.
Okay, I understand you guys are pleading insanity, claiming demonic spirits possess you to do these hideous murders. Can you please explain to this court how these so-called spirits made you into these raving madmen?
Bear witness as I exercise my exorcism. The evil that lurks within, the sin, the terrorism. Possessed by evil spirits, voices from the dead. I come forth with grave diggers in a head full of dread. I've been examined ever since I was semen. They took a sonogram and seen the image of a demon. At birth, nurses surrounded me with needles and drug me all up with the diseases of evil. Grew up in hell, now I dwell in an Islamic temple. I'm fighting a holy war in the mental. Look deep in my eyes, you see visions of death. Possessed by homicide is what I am obsessed. Giving niggas brain dimples. Dragging their asses on my hook by their temples. The cause of death is unknown to the cops. Cause when I kill them, I'm not leaving one element to our tops. First I'll assassinate them, and then I cremate them. Then take all of his fucking ashes and evaporate them. Or creep through the graveyard and hunt down your tombstone. Dig up your skeleton and stomp all your fucking bones. You try to haunt me, nigga, I ain't trying to hear it. Buck, I give your ass a holy spirit.
Can you please explain to this court when these problems first began?
The year 84, November, day 10th. Overwhelmed by the wicked inspirations of an evil gen. I realized my ideas has gone for 400 years of blood, sweat, and tears. I saw the torture, brutal murder of my father. So my brain became stained with the horror. I'm having reoccurring nightmares of being soaking wet, strapped down to the electric chair.
I got tackled with handcuffs and shackles and restrained in the bottom of a holy tabernacle. They gave me nothing to eat for 2 weeks and sold my eyelids open so I couldn't sleep. About to die from thirst, that's when the minister quenched my jaws with a cold glass of vinegar. Upon my wounds, they seasoned me with salt and knelt my hands and feet to the form of a cross. I cried as the blood dripped inside of my eye, refusing to die. Visions of hell tormented my fate, so I chewed my fucking arm off and made an escape.
With the defendant's explanation.
Into the realms of understanding and take good heed, and you could bleed while I'm scanning. 3 stages of pure hell, 60 cages of red cells. Raindrops hit the pales. Path is dull and narrow. You stalk by shadow. I pierced your skull with a fucking arrow. So narrow, only one could enter at a time. Stuck in the center, read the signs. 1,000 doors to choose. You better hurry. Don't stop. Shit is getting hot as a pot of curry. On your right side, there's fire. Your left, deep waters. Watch your step, there's deep waters. What's that coming through the floor? Is a claw. Took his fucking ass to the fucking core.
Stroll through the dark conditions. I stone you till I see sparks and friction. I chop you like a coal miner. Then combine the drug and mix it with your blood. Some more, I give you some more and watch you crawl. Guts hit the floor, worms exit your pores. I trick you, then I'm quick to syringe. Deep between my thoughts and bust out your skin. You scream, portraits of inflictable pain. You can't stand, you're up to your hands in quicksand. You're sinking and sinking deep into the earth. Thoughts was possessed since the first day of birth. My mentor says, it's my turn to possess the matter. Stab you with a dagger up Jacob's ladder. Thoughts become shattered, confused and tragic.
Thank you. Is there anyone jacking off to this right now?
Whoa. We're back. We're back, and I peed, so bladder's empty. That's the good news here on my end. We're gonna go right into the playground and do the Rabbit King. I saw a play called The Lizard King, and it was about Jim Morrison. I am the Lizard King, I can do anything. I think that was a lyric in a song. That's where that whole thing came from. Pikachu, you big Doors fan?
Are you a hacker?
I like Doors. I like the Doors. They're pretty good.
Come on, baby, take a chance with us and meet me on the back of a blue bus on a
blue bus. Yodel.
Come on, yeah.
You must think I'm garbage.
That kind of thing, like
that's
LA good, woman.
That's good. That's pretty good, Garrett. That's actually
all right, cool.
Really good.
Yeah, you gotta like, you know, the Doors. Who doesn't like the Doors, man? You driving at night through the desert, you gotta listen to the Doors.
Or like me, because I do graveyard shifts now.
Oh.
I listen to the classic rock station in our area, and
oh, yeah.
The Doors always come on.
Yeah, you know, I was working the night shift at one time, and I had a cassette tape I made, much like the cassette tape I made here we'll get to later. It had the Mystery Science Theater 3000 film. Do you remember they made a movie that was, I think the film they made fun of was This Island Earth, but it was the actual, like, theatrical version of the show. And it was just the soundtrack, and I would just listen to this side A, side B. I would listen to the fucking movie, because it was all just basically the jokes. I knew the scenes in my head.
Oh.
And I would listen to the soundtrack play out just while I worked, over and over and over again, just laughing my ass off. Exeter and the whole story of the mutant and Cal and, oh God, what memories.
Well, hey, that's not a bad way to pass the time. It's...
Dude, I loved it. I loved putting movies that I really, really liked. I had a couple other tapes that I made with just the, not the soundtrack like the score, but the actual sound of the movie. Oh, this is a fucking golfing game. Oh, how weird.
Like the, not the commentary, but I know what you mean.
But yeah, like I would record on a little cassette player like I have here, with the input, I would just record the output of my VCR, record the whole 2-hour movie, hour on each side of these like 90-minute tapes, and then, yeah, listen to that to pass the time on my Walkman at work. That was fucking great, man.
Not bad.
Stuff that I loved. Stuff that was like my favorite. Like I could visualize the scene. Stuff that was a lot of dialogue. I think I did Tarantino stuff, I want to say. Jackie Brown, I believe. Jackie Brown had so many fucking good lines in it. So much good conversation.
Like, yeah, that's what... Not on the same thing as you, but my freaking radio doesn't have, like, an aux jack, so I'm just bringing in my Bluetooth speaker.
Yeah.
And because I've been playing Persona 5 a lot,
oh, yeah.
I'm really digging the soundtrack, so I would always play the song that usually plays in the evening when you're in your attic, which is where you reside in this game.
You live in an attic, huh?
Yeah, because to try and give you just a quick synopsis... Basically, your character has been accused of doing a crime that he didn't commit because the chief police or whatever is pretty fucking corrupt.
You don't say.
Are you a hacker?
He tried to force himself onto a chick, and then your character's like, no, don't do that. But because he's got the connections, he got a police record on you.
Does this game deal with rape in some way? Attempted?
Actually, more or less, yes. In the very first palace or dungeon, actually deals with someone who has had accusations and allegations to trying to feel himself onto the high school girls.
Like rub up against them on a train kind of thing?
Yeah.
That basically. Shit. God damn it. Yeah, I don't condone that, but wow, that's...
I don't either.
That's a hell of a topic for a fucking JRPG.
And it's the very first boss you fight.
Wow. Gaming is...
Gaming got serious,
Gaming got a message, guy. This game has no message other than that frog looked funny. Mine's got an 8-ball on it, but dude, I'm right here at the hole. I'm gonna hit the fucking hole in three. Par three, baby.
All
hoppity hippity. Boom, into the hole. Frog
all
in. Thank you. Ooh, that's the wrong one. We want this one. I'll turn that down. It's a little loud, right?
They do sound to be a bit louder this time around.
How's that sound, Pikachu? Does that sound good to you?
Yeah.
I'm gonna do... Here, let me put a little loop on here for you.
Alright.
Alright. And I'm, let's add a little noise in here. Alright. You with me?
Yeah.
All right, and then I want you give me a couple vote. Just give me a little rap on the backside.
Yeah. All right. My name's Pikachu. I work at 7-Eleven during the night shift. I kind of don't like it because all these weirdos, they popping in trying to get beer at 2 in the morning. But I can't sell them because we got to close up the beer doors. They look at me going, what the fuck, man? What you trying to do? And it's like, hey, I'm just trying to do my job. Otherwise, I'm going to get fired and possibly sued.
Then
more people start walking in at 4 in the morning, want some coffee. And I'm all like, bro, what are you doing? You don't even got a car. Probably don't even have a job. Sorry.
Enough. You know what? I'm gonna say it right now.
What?
Some people say we don't have the rhythm, but I think me and you are gonna go do big things, if you know what I mean.
Hell yeah, boy.
See, you got the lingo down. Boy, you're like a rap god, Pikachu. That was intense, dude. Did I win that frog game? This is cute. I could have seen myself liking this a lot, especially if this was like... I was such a weeaboo in the PS2 and 1 days. Well, who am I fucking kidding?
Still
a weeaboo. The fact that this was Japanese too would have like really turned me on. Like, oh, I got Mr. Mosquito, this Japanese game. Oh, I got
Ribbit. It kind of has
frog.
More or less like a Katamari kind of aesthetic to it. You know what I mean?
It's got that aesthetic. It's got that aesthetic. The fly gets them. They get all paranoid and want that fly. Gets them off target.
Ooh, shit. That's actually pretty smart.
All right.
That's good game theory right
so
there.
So I'm gonna pull back. Where are we? I need to look. Oh, there's the hole. Oh, there it is. That looks like a bad thing. Whirlpool. Let's go right on the in between. But you hit these frogs, and they're.
It's kind of like golf, more or less.
Yeah. You kind of, it looks like a little lever. You hit him and it catapults him forward, and then it's up to him to where he wants to go. If he sees, maybe he gets distracted by one of them little flies.
He'll start going off the board.
Start going crazy. So now, I've been teasing this song. I want to play this Forced Life song. This fucking band, dude. I used to go see these guys. Well, I want to save that. I'll save the storytelling for the retrospective podcast that I do. Maybe I'll like fucking write shit. I'll get all professional, write notes for each song that I want to play, get the playlist ahead of time. It'll be cool, man, and I'll make sure to record the audio straight away, so if there's anything, I doubt anything would be copyrighted, but it won't be muted, and I can upload it to my personal YouTube. You know, the reason, and I've explained this, but I always see it in the comments on the PPS when this gets uploaded to the Archives channel. We do get copyright muted by Twitch automatically, and we have to upload that version to YouTube because we can't get the copyright thing again on our, Mega 64 Archives channel. So, unfortunately, yes, you should fucking watch on Wednesday. I'm sorry.
Gotta watch it live.
Gotta watch it Wednesday. You're here, Pikachu. Like, for years now, you've been watching.
Like, three years now, I think.
Yeah, we've only been going for four, and you've been around for quite some time. Hey, you're a regular caller now. Do you remember when Cody was a regular caller? Who were some of the first regular callers that we had?
Cody, definitely one of them. Another one who called back, for the first time in a long time, Dr. Ryan.
Dr. Ryan
was a regular.
Dr. Ryan was always good at helping out. Dr. Ryan was a good buddy.
He's a sage.
He's a healer. He's got magic hands and guilty fingers.
Hey, shouts out.
Take that to how you will.
I have asthma.
But basically, Ryan was there like in the early days of, I think, me and Barbara testing out like Minecraft from my MacBook Pro at my shitty house internet. I think he called in and helped us.
One someone mentioned, Yugnot.
Yugnot, that motherfucker. That piece of shit. Cocksucker!
It's a good thing he doesn't call in.
It is a fucking good thing
Yugnot
doesn't call in.
Fucking tarnish.
Exactly, and pull the fucking show down. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Fuck that guy.
Oh, son of a bitch.
Ugh, I just keep bringing him up.
Just reading that made me just, ugh. It feel nasty.
Made me want to just bring that beef back in. For you.
Having overlap going on.
Okay. It's too much. It's enough. Now listen, Pikachu, I think you probably had a point or some type of conversation that you had planned with me, or no?
Yeah, actually.
Were you going freeform today?
I don't mind going freeform with you, pal. It's always great to talk to you. But I did have a question regarding, because I want to try and go to Anime Expo this year.
Okay.
For the first time.
Why
and
not?
And what's troubling me is like hotels and whatnot, like, because
yeah.
I am a baby when it comes to this type
yeah,
of stuff.
Yeah. What do we got? Where are you? You're flying in? You would have to fly in.
If I can't use the truck, I'll probably just fly in, and it's not.
Where
that
would you be driving? Where would you be driving said truck from?
From my place here in Mesa.
Mesa, Arizona. Okay,
so
that's not that far.
Like a 6-hour trip.
Oh,
know?
Fuck tree, baby. 6-hour trip. See, would recommend, here's the thing. Hotels around that shitty ass downtown LA area are fucking expensive.
So yeah,
what
like
I do,
a night.
I stay in a cheap hotel, kind of far away, maybe like even 30 to 40 minutes away. But I get up early, I go have my breakfast, and then I drive in and park early before the parking garages are full.
Yeah.
And I just eat it on paying for the parking, but getting a cheap hotel. And having my car, having the ability to, like, get out of there when I'm done for the day. I don't know. That's how I did it, like, the last 2 years, and I did like that.
Okay.
Other years before, I've been lucky where, like, Mega 64 is getting us a room, and we're all staying there. Like, down the street, you know.
In the block, basically.
Yeah, like somewhere nearby walking distance. But my latest technique is going to like a Days Inn or like a seriously like $100-$125 to like $100 room. I won't go to like $79 rooms are just fucking nasty. Pubic hair on everything. Dude, I stayed in a $70 fucking hotel in Anaheim with Eric and Brian, and it's like a dark day we won't discuss because it was like heroin needles on the floor and fucking stained sheets.
What the fuck?
Oh, it was horrible. Last resort moments. But yeah, dude, stay in like $120 a night. Days in with a parking lot is what I look for, so I can park my vehicle and see it, and a restaurant attached, baby. So you get that breakfast in the morning, come down, get the breakfast, get in your car, go to Anime Expo, pay $20 to park in a parking lot early before it's full, and enjoy the con, man. Dress up like a fucking Jotaro or some shit they watch nowadays.
Yeah, the Joey Joes.
Jojo. That didn't
Jojo,
go over.
Something like that.
There, that went over. Hey, Ribbitopia, or this game in general, I don't know what the fuck, Ribbit Rabbit.
Ribbitopia.
Yeah, whatever. It's kind of, there's a lot of gameplay in the demo for the PlayStation demo disc. I don't even know if we're going to get to Slimeria. We're having so much fun, guys and gals.
It feels like one of those, like a comfy game. Like something that you would just want to sit on your couch after a long day. You know, have yourself a cold one.
Yeah.
You know, soda or beer.
Cheers,
whatever you
cold,
like.
A cold water. Uh-oh, this guy's about to get... Oh, snaked, son.
Fuck.
Oh, is that mine? No, that's him. Fuck him.
Yeah, yours is the panda one.
Yeah. That one's got the funny, like, fortune cookie symbol on his back. Okay, so... Oh, right. No, that's a whirlpool, baby. If we land right here, though, maybe we'll get that fly. Little bonus points.
And then just one last thing I wanted to add.
Yeah, so that answers the Anime Expo. You know how I'm going to rock it, but how are you going to rock it? So, all right, what's the other thing?
Probably the days in MMO. But the other thing I want to try and ask is, what would you recommend for a first-timer at AX?
Go to panels that interest you. Get one of those books when you get there that tell you what everything is, and like schedule out what panels and shit you want to go to. Check out, there's an arcade down there with stuff to play. You're gonna have so much time on the show floor. You'll definitely see it all. I say get there early, and then when you're fucking tired, if you're staying nearby. Well, it depends on if you're staying nearby or not. You just shoot up to the room and take a nap. Because, people seem to get a little sick of the show floor. Oh, fuck, I missed. Damn it.
Oh.
I don't know. Is that good advice? I don't know. That's
no, like whatever
I'm,
I can
I'm
take,
talking
man.
About like working. Like, when it's over, I like to go for a little nap and then at night go down to the arcade. Go to the. Oh, there's a lot of music and shit though too. You kind of got to be on it with the music. I feel like because a lot of it requires like separately purchased tickets, which is kind of fucked. Oh, for fucking real, that just little bump didn't get him in. Come on.
Like I heard fucking Teddy Lloyd's gonna be as part of like an as part of like a electronic music type of thing they're doing now.
Teddy Lloyd's gonna be there. I just saw that was announced. He was a nice guy. Cool guy. We met him out at TayoCon.
Hi.
AX is, it's fun. There's tons of shit to do. Not a lot of shit to eat around there. Although I think it's getting better. But, hey, like I said, if you're staying far away, then you can find food on the way back once you get out of downtown LA. I just don't like, downtown LA kind of fucking sucks.
Hey, And now
what's the word I'm trying to find? Too big? Too crowded?
Compacted by buildings, nowhere to park, and there's no real, it's like a business district with business buildings, and no real, like, there's like expensive fucking restaurants. There's like some sit-down restaurants, but not a lot of food options, and they're all kind of only over by Staples Center. I don't know. You know, there's a Starbucks, but the line's gonna be at least out the door and around the fucking block. Like, you know, there's a couple places, but they're all bombarded by AX, so that downtown area is just kind of fucked up if you're outside of the convention.
All right, well,
in my opinion.
Well, no, I know how it is with, like, but like there's town.
Go check out cosplay areas are kind of spread out all over, and you can just watch people, you know, in their cosplays getting their photos taken by all the cosplay photographers. There's tons of shit to do, like, in the surrounding courtyards and areas of the convention center. It's a cool convention center how it's all spread out. Artist Alley, they stuck it in the garage last year, and it was hot as hell, but...
Yeah,
you got. You're gonna have fun.
All right, cool, man. Right. Well, right, as long as I can try and get everything in motion.
All right, I'm gonna play this Forced Life song. I'm gonna play the first track, Still Beating.
Hell yeah.
I fucking remember this. I remember. I gotta save the stories for this. But this is an idea here, Pikachu. I think that guys and gals out there will get an idea of us. This is what some of the music kind of sounds like. Might not be everyone's cup of tea, but let me know if you're interested. Well, even if you're not interested, I'm still doing this. But yeah, here's just a little taste. And I gotta jack this cassette player up a bit. I'll switch to the other camera on this. So these tapes don't sound all that great. You can't really hear the vocal track, so you have to kind of pry the door open a little bit to get a full tone. You know what I mean, Pikachu?
Gotta get that full tone.
Now, I hope my cousin, just side note, hasn't been bugging you. I know she's been doing some kind of social media blasting on Snapchat or something lately, but...
I have not been,
fall victim
in her radar, I guess.
Not late, and not after your first run-in with her.
Maybe now she'll just back off.
Okay, well, that's wise. And wise words from Pikachu... Good night, my friend.
I'll see you around, Garrett. Thanks for taking my call.
I'll see ya. Okay, I'm gonna start the tape.
Later.
You're gonna hear a little fuzz there. Now, that was a previously recorded... whatever was previously recorded on this tape. Can't really hear that. Here we go. All right, we'll be back. If I'm having a good day, don't find anger, drink it, not someone that's a full mind is always there. I stand to face my night, white man in God. There's no evidence of a better tomorrow. I am for my like a terminal illness. And I can't be won't die. Gonna take me under. I'll be back on day. Never had a reason to. And it's all that I was in something in now. And yet you ask, if I had it, I'm going in. Throw my anger. Bring it through, someone that's a full fight is always there. From the world.
Yeah!
Destroy every day. Bring back the day. We'll be right back. Is that the end of track one? Alright. That's just a tease.
You must think I'm garbage.
No. Listen, it's very violent and aggressive music for young boys. That's all it is. So fucking tough. Fuck the world, destroy everything, respect nothing? Oh my god. Can you handle the angst, Jonathan? We are taking Jonathan V right now, and I'm putting in Valkyria profile, and I'm cranking. Oh, lightning from Four himself. How are you, Jonathan? Welcome.
I'm doing good. How are you? How are you this evening?
This evening finds me well, gentle sir. I've gotten some memories flooding back of dark, dank halls of sweaty boys and wife beaters moshing around. We're playing PS2 games. Dude, I'm reliving some fucking better days. My salad days.
That's the way to do it, to bring back some old memories, you know? Some old demo tapes from the old box underneath the bed.
Yeah, dude. I had to pry the cassette player open with the Apple remote a little. It's just like you need to pry it open a little bit to get... For some reason, like, the audio for the vocals is, like, recorded on the edge.
Well, that's the thing. Like, who knows how they record it? Because, you know, sometimes you just gotta go gorilla with a four track.
Dude, well, yeah, this was a demo tape that Forced Life made, and then I got a hold of it and made my copy of their demo tape.
Oh, a dub of a dub. Nice.
So this is my shit that whatever was on there, I crossed it out. You can see some three X's there. What was on there? Earth Christ. No, I don't know what it was. It's gone now. Forced Life, baby.
There it is, Forced Life.
So yeah, we'll get into more of that. A lot of Victory Records stuff. A lot of
you'll disobey Odin to your last.
God, a lot of like before hardcore got like nu metal, it was so just that like breakdowns.
Well, that's the thing. It reminded me of like some like Youth of Today mixed with some Judge.
Yeah. Oh, and old school shit too. Like the origins of. Where it comes from with Minor Threat and Gorilla Biscuits.
Exactly. I heard like Project X. Some Throwdown influence.
Yes.
Project X.
I got Throwdown CD. Like, I've got this vast collection of hardcore music that I don't really put into normal rotation anymore. You know, because I'm out of high school and
I feel you.
I don't need to get rid of all that tension.
You broaden your horizon with music.
Yeah. Yeah. The hardcore I do listen to now, it seems to have a gimmick associated with, you know, like Horse the Band or Graf Orlok, who are both on tour right now if they're coming through your city.
Yeah.
Shouts out. You should check it out. I talked
for
about
sure.
That show. It was really fun. Did you go to that?
No, I didn't, but I did see the announcement for that, though.
Gotcha,
and
gotcha.
I've been so busy going to other shows, it's just been like, what do I go to next? You know,
what's
worth my time and money at this point, you know?
Well, I know we've talked a little bit about going to shows and music on Twitter.
Yeah, I've always, I'm always like tagging you on my tweets, just be like, hey, start the day with this song, how about some Cro-Mags?
Dude, little Cro-Mags in the morning,
yeah,
just start
some Crass, why not? Start some with some Crass, yeah. Like Rude Awakening.
God, I want to talk about, I listened to that. That White Punks on Hope came on, and I was listening. You know, I heard that song for years and years, and I was like listening to the words and what was happening in the news, like within the last couple of months. And fuck, I was blown away.
It's so relevant,
dude.
Right?
Still today.
Yep.
So far away and so far in the future, it's like the same stupid things are what these guys are complaining about.
Are repeating, yeah, and Crass knew what was up, you know, they were hippies, basically doing punk.
Yeah.
But they were speaking truth, you know?
But it's so funny, like, anarchy, like, the way it ends, and their whole message of, like, anarchy and freedom, it's like, I don't know, if you're thinking I don't know if anarchy is the answer either, but, man.
That's the thing, it's kind of, like, very fantasy.
Yeah,
you know?
Well, that's what music is, that's what that hardcore song about, fuck the world, destroy everything, I respect nothing. It's like...
Yeah.
It's an art form to express whatever you want to express, and
exactly whatever's pent up inside. You know, you might not have the right
Yeah.
Where you don't want to hurt anybody, but you want to, like, shout out your feelings, you know, to the world.
And the hardcore scene was such a positive place and a positive thing. And it's weird.
Seven seconds, man. Posse hardcore.
You're getting out all of that, you know, when I was going to the dance floor, you know, I was getting out all of that teen aggression, first job aggression, high school aggression.
All those
problems go away when you're shouting, fuck the world, destroy everything.
Yeah.
I respect. And you just, you know, forget all of that shit and you get that energy just fucking out and you're so relaxed. And I remember sleeping with a ring in my ears
after you knew it was a good fucking joke.
So good.
You dig your head in the pillow and just be like, wow, that shit is still going.
For sure, man.
But
yeah.
Now, working 9 to 5, having a full-time job, responsibilities, to me now, it's even more powerful. I recently went to a show and I was like, dude, this is exactly why I continue doing this.
You know, to
like let out my aggression. And now that I'm older and now, you know, I'm kind of more seeing the world for what it is. It's kind of like I need this in my life, you know?
Yeah, I fall in and out of like a pattern where I'll go to a lot of concerts and then I'll stop for a while.
Yeah.
And that last show I went to, which was really a lot to drag me out, but it was Horse the Band and Graf Orlok.
Right.
And I was there and I was getting into it and it was a pretty good turnout. It was a sold out show for this little bar.
Oh shit.
So like tight, low ceiling, the best fucking place to see a punk band. It was full of fucking energy around the pit and I found myself like screaming out every word to every song that I knew, which was most of them. And then at the end, during Horse the Band's finale, you know, a guy that was next to me, kind of on the edge of the pit, saw that I was into it and singing along, but that I was reserved and hanging out on the outside and just kind of like...
Did he grab you and kind of
like
put his arm around
you? Oh, he fucking put his arm around my neck and dragged me... No words were ever spoken, but he dragged me right up front, and then we chanted the chorus along into the mic of whatever the last song was, and then... And then at the end of the show, you know, we fucking hugged each other and, you know, I don't even know who that guy was. I wouldn't recognize him today. But it was that understanding of like, this guy knows.
Yeah, we're here together. We love this band.
He knows
we're
I'm into it.
Right
and
now.
It's like, I needed that little push because I feel like I was definitely on the older side there. But shouts out to, there was a Mega 64 internet soldier for sure that recognized me there.
Cool.
Who I said hi to at the end of the night.
But, that's awesome. That's so cool.
Yeah, there's a new venue here too in San Diego that I like called the Observatory. It's like a chain, but they got a San Diego
satellite now. Observatory that's in Orange County?
I think it's the same management.
Okay.
But ours is an old, like, theater that got converted, and it's in North Park, which has decent parking. There's structures around and next door to the venue. I'm like into it, and I think last time I went there was for a Skinny Puppy show, but I would want to start seeing some more stuff that comes through. Even shit I'm not that into. Like, I came that fucking close, and I am actually kind of into Lil B. Shouts out to the littlest boss in the building.
I got bitches, yeah.
But I didn't go, and he played the Observatory, and I think Rocco's brother. I think Dumpin went. Shouts out to Y2K Based.
Yeah.
This game looks good for PS2. Like, you know, we've come a long way with, like, Nier.
The classic PS2 games.
But PS2, I just keep playing my old games, man. I'm not paying attention to the story, so I'll totally not know what to do since this is an RPG.
You know, seeing all the demo discs, that reminded me of all the PlayStation Underground demo discs I just have, just... stashed somewhere. And
you know what, I have these Game Pro discs too, but I can't get them to load. They when I put them in the PS2, they say like, please insert PS2 media.
Oh, that's interesting.
I don't know why they won't load, but I got the only other one I didn't do. Whoops. which I know it has this bitchin' demo for a game. I forget what the name of it is, but you talk to the game and the character actually like moves around based on your voice commands into the that like SOCOM. The first PS2 mic came with SOCOM Navy SEALs.
I remember that, and then you had to shout out the commands to your squad.
And I remember telling the girl like, go into the bathroom, take off your clothes, and she was like, no. Like, she, like, defiantly, it knew what I was saying, and this game claimed to have, like, a huge library of words that the character knew. God, what was, no one knows it yet. This cutscene is still happening. Jesus. Lifeline.
What's up with these cutscenes?
Thank you, crazy psycho. Guys, we got a crazy psycho in the chat. Someone call the police.
Thanks.
Oh, shit. I tweeted you earlier today to see what size shirt you are, because my homie has a distro, a screen printing distro. Wanted to send you some samples that you'd probably like.
Tight. Send them to the P.O. Box care of the PPS.
For sure, I will.
Thanks,
definitely,
man. I'll check it out. I'll show it off on the... I mean, God, if they're cool, I'll plug them. Kip sent me this hat, and now he can't get...
It blew up.
Dude, people on Twitter keep asking me where I got it. I wore it a bunch of times here. Apparently no one watches the fucking show. What the hell? I know what it is. I don't got main guy. Other main guys.
I have a question. Back in the day, you used to rock the bullabout, and I used to also rock the bullabout.
Yeah.
What's up? You don't wear it anymore. What happened?
It's a new age.
It's a hassle, right?
It's a fucking new age with the gun violence that's going on.
Oh, yeah. You know what? So, back in high school, punk as fuck, wore the bullabout to school, you know?
Oh, yeah.
And obviously it was banned right away. I was taken to the principal's office and had to show them that the shells were empty, you know? And after that, they sent me home.
Yeah.
And then the next day, the announcement over the intercom was like, you cannot bring like paraphernalia like this. Blah,
you
blah,
made
blah.
Them announce to the whole school.
Yeah, and everybody in class was just like, it's John's fault. It's John's fault. But dude, I didn't care. To me, it was funny. It was just something that a shock value that I knew that I would get in trouble for, but didn't care at the time, you know?
Yeah, I had a friend, Kyle, who wore a Marilyn Manson shirt that said, I am the god of fuck on the back of it.
Oh, I had a friend that
and
wore...
we were like, yeah. Kyle, like, you know they're going to make you turn inside out. He's like, like, so what?
I had
like,
a friend that
he didn't
that
care.
Wore that. Yeah, I had a friend that wore that Cradle of Filth shirt with the nun.
Oh yeah,
banging herself with the cross, and I was like, "What are you doing here?"
Shut the fuck up.
Yeah, man. Yeah, I don't know. As kids, we were dumb as fuck. I remember wearing the spiked leather bracelet with these metal spikes on it to PE, and then we had a substitute, and he was this old man who was like, "What the fuck are you doing? You got weapons on. We're playing basketball. To give me that shit." And they threw it away. I was all pissed off, but, you know, just being a dumb fucking kid.
Talking about clothes that got me in trouble, last week you were playing Tony Hawk Pro Skater 3.
Yeah.
And that reminded me, I had old hookup sweater with all the anime chicks.
Shouts out.
You know, exposing their panties, you know, and I was like, hell, all about it. And then I went to school, and that was, like, the first time ever... Like going against the rules, we had a uniform policy, and I wore it with pride.
Yeah.
And my history teacher, she hated me and sent me home because of my pornographic shirt that she said that. Yeah.
I had a Gunsmith Cats T-shirt. I still have it, but it had one of the characters up against the bedroom wall in her panties with a gun. And I remember getting in trouble for that shirt, not because she was in her panties. But because, and I know everyone fucking hates that word, but because she had a gun, and they were like, you can't have a gun on your shirt at school.
God.
I was like, this is like a cartoon, though. It's a fucking, it's a, not even a real gun.
I had a Ghost in the Shell shirt, and it was the cover of the VHS tape, and had a gun, and you could see her cleavage straight out.
Hell yeah.
And that was another time I got in trouble for wearing something I shouldn't have at school.
Dude, fucking teachers have got to hate on us for expressing... our inner desires of anime titties.
Of expression. Yeah, anime titties.
We want to see anime titties 24/7. I want to look down at my shirt. I want to see anime titties. I want to lift up my side and see anime titties on my own chest. I got exactly. titties on titties.
Some crazy Tumblr shit. Why not?
You're right about that. You are right. Jonathan, thank you for calling in. We're running long. Do you have any closing words? I'll give you the floor. The show floor. All right.
Any closing words? Well, yeah. Any closing words would be keep watching the PPS, everybody.
Yeah. We got to get, you know, we get some views on the Mega 64 archives. But, you know, the views live when the show is on air at 7 p.m. Pacific every Wednesday. Boom. That's where...
Gotta tune in.
That's where you get all the music, no muting.
Yeah. Gotta watch it live.
Brilliant.
Come on. Live in the moment.
Fucking brilliance. You got...
So I want to...
You got guys in Finland
staying
up till 5 a.m. What's your excuse? Yeah.
My request is, I saw that you, I saw your music selection, I think it was like 2 weeks ago.
Okay.
Do you have any Atari Teenage Riot?
I don't have any music by Atari Teenage Riot, no.
Or how about...
What's their biggest hit? Because I've heard the name of that band.
You know what? You guys were talking about Tokyo Drift. Do you know that song Speed? It comes out like in the car chase scene, I think.
No, I'm not as familiar, and frankly, I was getting very close to killing Ryan's discussion.
Yeah, that was a pretty long conversation. I was like walking home listening to this.
I opened Pandora's box, and that pussy stank.
Hey, you know what?
That's an innuendo.
Let's end on some Crass. Why not? Play some Crass, and I'm out of here.
Oh, okay. You want to hear a Crass song?
Hey, yeah, let's play some Crass. Let's play.
Well, I talked about. Do I have them on here? I think they're on my iPad for sure.
Just curious. But you said you're the princess.
Should I play?
Of the
we were talking
right?
about the
White Punks
on Hope. Yeah.
Yeah. Why not? Let's play some White Punks on Hope.
Yeah. I think.
And where have you been all this time?
Oh, I only have Penis Envy.
The only daughter of King. Oh,
Penis Envy.
I like Penis Envy though, because that was all the female singer.
Yeah. Where
have you been?
Eve Libertine. How about some subhumans? How about some Drugs of Youth?
Do I have any subhumans? Let's see. I think I might have one subhuman song, and it's probably like the popular one.
Religious War?
Hold on, I don't know.
Apathy.
The name's Rufus.
I never use the search. Oh no, I don't have any on my iPad.
Oh man, let's just play
what about
some
that
old
Crass?
School.
How about that? We'll still go with Crass.
Yeah, we'll go with Crass. Everyone's got
everyone check
Crass.
My Twitter if you want to look up that other one. Oh, I fucking lost him. Here. Poison in a pretty pill. Good night, Jonathan.
Good night. Have a good one.
Have a good one. And I will gear up and head into battle. That's right, baby. Lost Forest. This is the PPS 2, number 17. I'm going long today. Why not? It's a long format. A lot of talk up on this track. Yeah, I gotta hit the post, though. You don't want to miss it. And we'll be right back.
Live.
Oh.
We got company.
We got company, but we're only halfway done with a song.
I can use my power here.
There's callers. Be patient, I will get to you. By ear. It's been a while. Oh, it's been a while. Oh my god. I think he can dodge this. We've got Andrew. He was here first. Sorry, Max. We will get there. Andrew, how are you? How the hell are you, bud?
This gothic night. I'm in the darkness style right now. I'm vaping hard.
Oh, you're vaping in the dark?
Which trap? Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I'm in the darkness. I'm not physically in the dark.
Oh, you're not vaping. You're not vaping in the dark.
I'm in the darkness. I'm in the style. I'm gothic.
Okay, but you're not vape. You're not vaping.
I am vaping.
Oh, you are vaping, and you're in the style of darkness.
Of course.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now I have a full understanding of what I'm dealing with. Thank you. Oh, good to hear it, man. I think there's not enough darkness, and gothic, decorum out there in the world anymore.
Yeah, I want to bring it back. There's too many posers in it too, you know, like, I feel like the gothics now, they're the real goths.
Yeah, the only ones, it's the rare breed, the only ones left. But can there be new goths?
Well, there's new goth subgenres, you know that.
Yeah, well, I mean, I hear a lot about health goth, and people think there's music attached, but I say no.
Yeah, there's health goth, there's cyber goth.
Oh, that's cyber goth, but that's like EDM. I don't know why. I don't know. Goth is like The Cure, and
regular goth like synth punk.
Yeah, well, like post punk, and like it seems like all the music I like came out of punk or some form of it. Because hardcore, same thing, is a subgenre of punk music, essentially.
Yeah, I'm trying to get into all that. I've been listening to Danzig a lot.
Oh, yeah.
It's great.
Some good Danzig. For How the Gods Kill? Woo! That's the best album.
Dude, that is my number one song right now.
Best song right now. Oh, best song of all time, I think. It's definitely a ballad. But that one goes down as the best Danzig song.
Yes.
I would agree.
I like Sis. Is it Sistina's? I don't know how it's pronounced.
Sistina's.
But that's I feel like I feel like it's his best song, but it's not my favorite. If that makes sense.
I remember seeing Danzig played at a venue called Soma Live here a couple years ago, and I went. And
how was that?
Well, I'll tell you how it was. I remember in the encore, he played Sistina's and then She Rides. You know She Rides?
Yeah.
And during She Rides, there was a stripper getting so fucking into the song.
Is there anyone jacking off to this right now?
And she was on her boyfriend's shoulders. She was like on his shoulders watching the stage right behind me. She took her top off and was just out to the music, just let loose upon the world. She is the night. She was like swaying them back and forth, and they were huge fake boobs. It was insanity.
Dude, I would have popped the weasel hard.
I kept, dude, I was there with my girlfriend. I mean, like, I kind of like, oh my god, I saw it behind me, like, holy shit.
You gotta act like you were shocked or something.
I tapped everyone around, was like, look at what's going on above us. Oh, it was great. And I have Sistina's to thank for that. Oh, Alicia died. That's not good when that happens.
What?
Oh god, Alicia's dead. Rufus has to move on without Alicia. Alright, here we go.
Hey,
now I'm dead.
I wanted to talk to you about Ham Pal 93, brother which I care for. Not necessarily the documentary.
Well, I think that documentary by Trapped is maybe... I can't... Sometimes I go back and forth between, is the Gothic King Cobra one better, or is the My Brother in Which I Care For? Now, I didn't know anything about the two brothers before the documentary. Fuck, I don't know.
Yeah.
That one is insightful and fucked up.
I fucking love Hamilton and Hudson. I would take a bullet for them. You need to check out their YouTube channel.
Are they still doing fire trucks?
They have been doing vlogs. Hamilton has.
Dogs?
It's fucking hilarious.
He likes to film
vlogs.
Dogs.
Vlogs.
Oh, vlogs.
He calls them blogs, though.
Vlogs. Okay, okay. Is Hamilton the one who was hooking up with dudes online?
Yeah, dude, that
got kind of scary at the end of the documentary, because I'm like, I feel like you could... Is that taking advantage of these young boys?
Well, like, Hamilton talked about it in one of his vlogs. He said he's like a curious George. He's got to try out everything once, you know?
Oh, my
like,
God. What
Hamilton
a fucking
is
analogy.
So funny.
How did he say it? Can you do a Hamilton impression?
Fuck. Not necessarily on that, but...
I'm not curious, George. I gotta try out everything. Holy shit.
He's talking about masturbation. He goes like, yeah, man, I love that masturbation, you know.
Gotta love it.
When you get caught by your parents, that's your downest time, man. That's what he says.
His parents adopted those two twin boys from a different country, right? They're Slavic?
There's a lot of... Ukrainian or something.
Okay.
Something like that.
They
adopted these
two boys who have, you know, some developmental disability. And they're trying to raise them, right? And they get online and someone's making... I keep thinking about these fucking old people who adopted them. Who were like...
They love Dan Schneider. They love iCarly.
They're having to deal with their vlogs and this fucking documentary that comes out and like... The fire department
so much
yelling
to talk
at him.
About.
Oh, God, these parents
like,
are
they're trying to make
saints.
A Uber reality TV show right now.
These
they
two,
recorded them driving around doing the Uber.
These two saints that adopted, that's what I want to do. When I'm like established millionaire, I'm going to adopt two kids that really need it. And I'm going to just fucking...
I'm going to adopt Hamilton.
I'm going to adopt... Well, you're going to have to... I don't know. Hamilton's his own... He's his brother in which he cares for.
Yeah.
They take care of each other, you know? You can't separate those two boys.
Yeah, dude. I'm
How
excited.
How old are they now? God.
Hamilton, they're twins. Hamilton's probably like 21 or 22,
dude,
20,
are they drinking?
Around there.
See, shit gets
scary.
Yeah, dude,
they
like,
drink. They
like,
party.
Raymond 14 went from being like cute, crazy kid to like terror level 7, scary, homeless, conspiracy theorist. So,
wait, what's that, by the end of the documentary?
It's weird. What's that?
Are you talking about how it got crazy at the end of the
documentary? No, I'm talking about, like, young YouTube personalities growing up and getting fucking crazy. Like, Raymond 14.
Oh, yeah, I know what you mean.
Raymond 14 started when he was 14 years old. That's why his channel was Raymond 14. And then, like, he grew up and got, you know, Ted Kaczynski-level terrorizer.
So
Ham Pal growing up, I feel like could get, you know, when they start drinking, and I mean they're gonna turn into Gothic King Cobra.
They've started drinking, dude.
Oh, I hope Wendy's is hiring.
Nah, they got Publix. Hamilton's been going to college. He's doing good in college right now, I'm pretty sure.
I'm skipping sequences. He's
got his own room.
Dial. without saving. He's got his own room. Are they, they're not together then? They're going to college separately?
Well, Hamilton's got a, he's got his own apartment. He goes home on the weekends to do his blog and shoot his emergency videos with Hudson and do Uber.
Oh, he's an Uber like driver.
Yeah, they're trying to get a reality TV show with Uber. They're trying to make their own Uber reality TV show. They uploaded a video. It's pretty great.
Okay, I'm gonna have to check back in with the Ham Pal boys. where are you from? Are you near them, Andrew?
Siena.
Siena, Georgia?
No. Louisiana.
Louisiana. Why did I think Siena was in Georgia?
I might go meet them. They like fan meetups. They did one a while back.
Dude,
they did a fan meetup. I watched this video. I was like, who is like wanting to meet up with them? They drove out to meet their fans. Fucking like 15 hot ass college girls.
What?
No joke.
And they're probably hitting on them because this is what they like, you know?
Well, look, my mind was blown. I was watching that and they're eating and stuff and they're talking about what they should like be vlogging about. It cuts to Hamilton in the car and he's like, they ditched us. I was like, oh my fucking god.
Oh no.
It's bad.
You know what? Reality set in for those poor girls.
Yeah, they didn't know what they were getting into.
Because I can tell you, I can guarantee you, Ham Pal's got something on their mind, and it ain't.
Dude, he is trying to slay.
Signatures.
No. I need a signature.
Well, yeah, I mean, they were looking for groupies. That's the best part of YouTube, man. The groupies.
They're working hard.
That's why I went to VidCon once. See how there's laughter after jokes? Because VidCon. Yeah, man. Well, I'm going to check out the Ham Pal boys, Andrew. And I'm going to let you have some closing words as I skip this sequence once again.
Dude, I got no closing words. Okay. I watched Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Let's end people on that.
Think about
you
that
like,
guy.
Do you like Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2?
I never saw it. I only watched the original.
It's great. The second one is a little more splatstick, kind of, you know? There's a little more humor in it, but Texas Chainsaw 2 is great too. But yeah, the first one's horrible.
That is horrible. Like,
I mean, like, horrific, like, terror. When he slams that fucking metal door, he picks that girl up and carries her ass. Woo!
That fucking threw out all the traditional shit. Like, you did not expect that. Like,
dude, praise. Hey, credit where credit is due to the man, Toby Hooper. Shouts out. Round of applause for Mr. Hooper. Let's hear it for Texas Chainsaws all around. Lick my plate, you dog dick. We'll see you later, Andrew.
Alright, later.
That'll make sense to him eventually when he sees the movie. Now, Max, I did promise to get to you, and you're a saint, and you're still there. How the hell are you?
Yo, Garrett.
Yo, what's up, bud?
What's going on, man? This is
Max.
Actually the first
stick to the battle plan.
Max Daddy, Maximo. You ever play those games, Maximo? It was like the sequel to Ghost and Goblins or whatever.
I've literally never heard of that.
No, it was cool, man. When you got hit, your armor came off. You were in boxers.
Oh, is that like that's the NES game, right? Or SNES?
Yeah. I think it was like Ghosts and Goblins, and then on Super NES it was like Ghouls and Ghosts, and then it was Maximo on PlayStation, something like that. Something like that. I could be wrong. I am wrong, I'm almost positive.
Shut the fuck up.
But anyway, Max, I fucking love hitting buttons today. You wanna, here, let me see what this sounds like. What do you think?
It's like a, I don't know, it's like a now it's gone.
That's got a little more depth in it.
Exactly, did we just find?
Something not needed. Cool, I can just hear this. This could just be the call.
Yeah, just this beat. I should change it up a little. The psychic energy possesses the body.
Uses it as a sort of vessel.
I don't like that tap delay. That fucks it up. Yeah, that's good.
Sure.
All right.
You like put enough in the. Oh, okay, never mind.
What? Did you have an idea?
Yeah, I was gonna say if you can put in the Return to Innocence and you know mix it up with that shit.
All right. Oh, I gotcha. All right. It's just that the BPM. Hold on. We got BPM sync issues. It's so loud, that effect. That's the thing. Our volumes aren't really set up, and we're projecting photons right now anyway.
Oh yeah. That's
what
fair.
Am I getting into? But Max, back to basics.
Sure.
What can I do for you today?
Well, I guess I have a story for you.
Oh wow, I love it.
Yeah, you know of the game that's coming out. It's called Death Stranding.
Yeah, we were speaking about Hideo Kojima earlier. Yeah, Death Stranding.
Yeah, exactly. I'm part of a community of people who believe this game is actually Metal Gear Solid 6.
Wow! Oh my fucking god. You're dropping crazy woke-ass knowledge. I'm gonna die because I can't get to the...
So what?
Pay fucking attention.
So what?
You say it's Metal Gear 6.
Yeah.
Jesus.
I mean,
how can he do that with... You think the whole fight with Konami is really... They're still gonna publish his stuff?
Oh, definitely. Yeah, why not?
But why wouldn't it be Fox Engine? Why would it be this Guerrilla Games thing?
I think Guerrilla Games of the what's it called, Decima, and Fox Engine are actually working in tandem.
Ooh.
Like I don't know if you could do that with engines, like you can combine them or something.
I don't think so. I don't know. I think the way the architecture's written, that wouldn't work out. But I don't know anything about programming. And I say a word like architecture out there like I know what I'm talking about. But I don't.
What the fuck?
But so, yeah, he and a group of people have actually spoken to Kojima, but it's not real conversation. It's kind of like one of us referred to it as a smoke signal.
So you've been contacting and speaking with some deep throat type character who you feel is Kojima.
Well, yeah.
Oh my god, this is
we've never met face to face.
This is getting okay. I'm still with you. Okay. Now, how do you contact this person? Is it through a Tor browser? What are we encrypting?
Yeah, you gotta download deepweb.net, and you gotta do some shit there.
And you gotta do
know.
Some kind of Silk Road thing?
Exactly. Okay. You have to buy, like, fake drugs off some guy, and he'll meet you, and he'll give you a link to someone's Twitter, and it's actually...
Oh.
I don't know.
Fuck.
No, but on his Japanese account, he posts photos of, like, you know... Have you ever seen it? He posts photos of like a song he's listening to, or
yeah, all the time. He's way into movies, music, and toys. It seems.
Yeah, no. Basically, one of us he posts a link to a song, and about a day later, or maybe in the same day, Kojima posts the link to that song or a photo of his song. I mean, his phone listening to that song.
So he's spying on you.
Yeah, basically, he sees what we post. And he reposts it in a different way.
And this posting is being done by your group's Metal Gear 6 Theory Association?
Yeah, we're all just a bunch of weirdo, crazy people.
What's the name of this Twitter account? Oh my god.
That we're talking to?
Well, that you're talking to him through, yes.
Oh, it's all our own accounts. That
oh, he's just happening to follow all of your own accounts.
Well, we've contacted him, and he responds with the photos.
Wait, wow. Okay.
So he posted, one of our group members posted a song, some song called Wonderland by some band called Take That or whatever.
Okay.
And then the same day, Kojima posts that song and that title. And little hints to things that we've posted, like, God, I'm trying to remember one off the top of my head. I can't remember exactly. I changed my Twitter banner to, what's his name? The Raiden from Red Revengeance.
Oh, yeah.
And, that same day, Kojima posted, a link to, just, it was today, actually. He posted a gif of like a table covered in the armor from Revengeance.
And, see, now, oh my god. It's fucking, dude, that's the correlation. This is like Bohemian Grove level stuff. He's putting armor on his Twitter, and you're talking about a game he made that has the same armor in it.
So often, there's so many coincidences.
It's a lot of coincidences, but like everything with Kojima is like mysterious coincidences. It's like that's why there's so many people on YouTube like having you guys, do you have any YouTube videos that you have kind of stated backed up with like evidence of like circling the tweets and like showing the time stamping and stuff? You could show all this evidence?
There's no evidence. That it's all complete, like in our minds thinking, oh, this is what he's saying.
Okay. All right. But, and what's the real fact that's going to put me over the edge, make me, because I'm with you 110%, but what's going to get me to 111?
So what?
What is the one nugget that makes me know Death Stranding on PS4 is gonna be Metal Gear 5?
Nothing at all, I guess.
You don't have a closing argument. It's just give up.
Yeah, basically. Oh, let's see if I can think of one.
You got it.
Hello.
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, I thought my phone hung up. Hold on.
I'm waiting for the. Oh, that's how you do it.
Okay, here we go.
Yeah.
I posted a photo. When I first started talking to these guys, I wanted to see if they're full of shit or not. So I decided to do my own experiment, and I tried to speak to Kojima myself.
Yeah, what did you ask him that he replied with?
I don't think I asked him a question. I think I just posted a photo. Let me see if I can get to it.
Okay, but he was in the photo? Like, his name was in the tweet, so he saw it?
Yeah, I tagged his Twitter with it.
Okay.
And he. Okay, he was talking.
He doesn't follow you, does he?
No, he doesn't.
Okay.
He's
got to search your name out and look you up every day.
I suppose, yeah.
I hope everyone's enjoying the live broadcast.
Does David Hayter know about
this? How Twitter works, if you tag someone on Twitter, they see that you're in that conversation, they could just respond there.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
But yeah, so. I saw he was talking about that Beauty and the Beast movie.
Real quick, hold on. Take that. Rewind that real quick. Let's hold on a second.
There you go.
I keep hearing a very familiar. Katie knows what I'm talking about. Back this up. Hold on a second. I keep hearing a very familiar beep in the background. You wouldn't happen to have a smoke detector that needs a battery replaced, would you?
That's actually correct.
Oh, fucking hell. I mean, this is a total safety hazard. I mean, right now, I'm going to need you, Max. I'm going to need you to get a ladder. Don't stand on your chair. That's not safe. You're going
to
slip, fall, the rollers. Come on.
Fair. All right.
But you got to get a 9-volt in there, man. What if there's a fire tonight and you burn alive? Then I don't have a conversation next week?
Well, I'm in an abandoned warehouse with the rest of these guys, so.
Oh, God. It's not that big. You guys are doing some squatter type shit, and you're gonna light something on fire on accident and have to.
Yeah, we made a Kojima effigy, and we're just like, you know, jacking off on it.
You guys are just doing meth and jacking off on a printout, laser print. It's getting smeared by cum. It's fucked up.
Exactly. No, that's night for me, really. But yeah, so he posted a link to some Beauty and the Beast thing.
This wizard is wild. Yeah. Okay.
I responded to him with. Just a link to something that was related to it. I can't find it exactly, but I
let's get to the point. Yes. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So basically,
sorry.
He responded to a poster for some movie, and that poster was released on February 23rd, and he retweeted it like a week ago for no reason, and then
the date it came out
was my birthday, and that birthday is on the front page of my Twitter.
Oh my god. Okay, that's the piece I needed. I'm a full believer, 111%. I want you to DM me the location of your address. I want of your warehouse where you guys are having this Kojima circle jerk and doing the meth and the whole thing. I want in. I'm with this lifestyle. I want to play Metal Gear 6 that bad. Max, I look forward to your contact. through Tor on a secure line. Do you understand? Blink yes if you get me. If you understand, Max.
What's that?
I want in, and I want acknowledgement. Do you acknowledge? The CIA is penetrating my line. Clearly, Max is being taken off and is being tampered with. Max, just blink twice. Send me the DM. You and me, Max. Oh my God. MGS3. We're getting chapter peace. It's coming. I'm coming. He was coming on a photo. Disrespectful. We'll be right back.
So what?
Have one kiss.
Oh my God, my 8 megabyte memory card's gonna fill up. That's the end of the track. And We're getting to the end of the show as well. Well over the hour and a half limit. But I do want to go lightning round. There were some... Let's see if we... Oh, Kevin, I was going to get to you. Oh, Kevin, I was going to go lightning round on you. I don't want to overwrite. But you're going to call right back in because you know it. You knew it, Kev. You're with me. Give a round of applause to Kev.
Oh, hey, man. I thought I was listening to the stream for a second there.
Yeah, no, you're here. You're with me. I have hey. You now.
You must think I'm garbage.
Be warned.
What is the point of the call?
Just wanted to make sure you select Killer Clowns from Outer Space.
Oh! You know I did. Did you hear me talk about it on the podcast?
No.
Oh, like two podcasts ago, I think I mentioned it. Maybe it was after show. And I was like, yeah, I gotta talk to Kevin about that. Well, although I couldn't remember Kevin was Kevin. But, Kevin.
All right, man. Well, I haven't seen it.
I did see it. I watched it on Netflix. It was great, man. I mean, right in line. And Derek was like, oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You would love that movie. Like, he totally agreed with you.
All right, I got another one for you, though.
Okay, what's next?
Although, you might have seen this one, actually. It's called Night of the Creeps.
Oh, well, wait a minute. Yeah. Night of the Creeps. Have I seen that?
It's the, alien slugs.
Yes, and is that where you get the old man who does the carousel of death? Yes, I've definitely seen Night of the Creeps. Rocco really loves that movie, too.
Wait, what? Carousel of death?
Well, that's what he calls it at some point, at the end, isn't there a cop and he's got like a revolver and he spins around in a circle in the living room.
Thinking of Logan's.
And shoots all the infected slug zombies in the head.
I just watched this movie like yesterday. And I can't remember that.
Does it have an old man cop character who's like got a mustache?
He always goes, thrill me.
Yeah, thrill me. Yeah,
the worst line
detective.
Ever.
Thrill me. Yeah, okay, that's what I'm talking about.
What kind of an asshole would say that?
Carousel of death, baby.
He goes up on a murder scene and says, thrill me.
Thrill me. well, yeah, dude. I've seen Night of the Creeps. Let's see, I got one for you. I got one for you.
Oh, yeah, go for it.
Tromeo and Juliet. Tromeo with a T, like T-R-O-M-A.
Yeah, I haven't seen this, but what the hell is this?
It's,
oh my god.
It's Troma's... Troma's like a very indie film company out of New York, out of Tromaville. They make the Toxic Avenger movies and stuff.
Is it like a monster penis?
Well, yeah, there is a monster penis in there. There's also a cameo by sexiest Street Fighter character out there. Let me get a...
Is there anyone jacking off to this right now?
Let me get a replay on the cami thing here. Hold on a sec. Take that back. A cameo from, Lemmy himself, the Motorhead, frontman. There was even on the DVD, there's a special feature with Matt and Trey Parker.
Really?
Yeah, Tromeo and Juliet is, I think, my favorite Troma film. And it's their version of Romeo and Juliet, directed by Lloyd Kaufman.
Yeah, definitely check this out. It looks like there's a lot of like old school animatronics and stuff in it.
There's some great like low budget practical effects. Like I always talk about these movies as being huge inspirations for me working with Mega 64.
Let me ask you an
example of that.
So I'm a big fan of horror films.
I'm a big fan of water to wet my whistle. Fucking nothing here. Yeah, go ahead. I can hear you.
And some friends and I are talking about, the golden age of horror and how it kind of peaked in the 80s as far as budget goes and, you know, the amount of people that were making animatronics in the 80s. And it's the practical effects back then. And we were thinking, even if you had the budget now, do you think that you could pull together enough talent to make something like, you know, the peak of the budgets that they had for, you know, Nightmare on Elm
Street? So, man. I think that the technology for the makeup and the practical effects stuff is so fucking good. Some of the stuff that I see coming out of, like, the companies, like, Smooth On and their social media, just, like, what people do with their products, it's fucking amazing. I just don't think that there's a lot of market for those films, so they don't make that stuff. You don't really see it outside of like people's school projects and stuff. But and that kind of goes as far as like I think the talent's there because people are making incredible stuff. But I just don't know that they make those type of movies anymore. But I think the talent's there.
Yeah, I mean they kind of stopped making slasher films. And
yeah.
After the 30 Nightmare on Elm Street and
it seems like
movies.
Anything on TV that has blood in it is K&B Effects has got the fucking market cornered.
Oh, I try watching that Scream TV show because I love the Scream movies. They use a lot of that, just like After Effects plugin. It's the awful digital blood.
Hate digital blood. It's so fucking obnoxious.
There's a scene where one of the main girls is stabbing somebody, and it's just that's coming up from like off camera.
Yeah, even do it in like shows I like. Like I really like Ash vs. the Evil Dead, and I'm watching the second season of that. The first season
I never
had
checked
a lot
that out.
Of it too.
Is it any good?
If you like Evil Dead, I would definitely check out the show or the who is it? Is it FX I think that's doing it?
Maybe Fox. I don't know.
No, I think it's FX or okay. FX or whatever you say. I don't know how they say it.
Yeah, they've been trying to do a lot of like TV shows that are kind of based on horror, and a lot of them are awful.
This is good because it's all Sam Raimi producing. It's all the old actors, back working on it. It's really fucking cool. And there's like footage. At least in season two, they got licensed to use footage from the first two Evil Dead films and Army of Darkness. Actually, I think only the first season had Evil Dead 2 stuff or something like that. But now they're like using flashback footage from all the movies. It's all kind of tied in. It's fucking cool, man. It's a good show. If you like the Evil Dead franchise, if you like Ash, it's that character. It's Bruce Campbell at his best,
Yeah, I'll definitely check that out. I feel like, over the past few years, I've been going through all the old horror movies, and I'm kind of running out.
Just rewatch Bubba Hotep again. there's greats out there that I'll pull up every, October when Halloween rolls around.
Oh yeah,
I got my favorites, but new stuff. Yeah, you don't see much new stuff. I watched. I watched something new. What in the fuck was that called? It's not gonna come to me. But there's indie stuff out there. Like you see stuff come to like Netflix and Hulu, but it's kind of like sci-fi original looking. Some of it's okay.
Yeah, I don't mind that. I've been watching the Outer Limits. I never really got into that show.
Oh yeah.
I feel like it's a Twilight Zone ripoff, but I love it.
For sure. But maybe produced by the same people or something.
Yeah, I don't know. I think there's enough time in between the end of the Twilight Zone, when the Outer Limits began. I mean, the Outer Limits was early '90s. I feel like late '80s.
Ein Herrier.
There was an episode where. I saw when I was a kid, there's like a finger coming out of the sink.
Oh.
And this guy was this guy's eating ice cream on the couch watching TV, and he kind of hears a coming from the bathroom. He just
murmur.
Goes over to try and figure out what it was, and he couldn't figure it out. And eventually, his finger just comes out of the sink, the sinkhole, and like starts waving to him.
Isn't that weird how when you see shit like that when you're like a little kid, it really freaks you out and it sticks with you? Like, that was so fucking scary, that finger.
Oh yeah, I spent so long trying to figure out what that was from.
And then you did. Oh man.
Yeah. And I think at the end, a hand comes out of the toilet and he like chop chains. Well, I'm spoiling this, but I don't even remember.
Hey, that reminds me of when I was a little kid, I saw a movie where like a guy had like, much like in Evil Dead, an eyeball started growing out of his shoulder, like a lump he had. And I could never figure out what it was, and it freaked me out because eventually it grew like a whole head and it was a whole thing. And I remember seeing that as a little kid, like the eye and the new body and head started popping out of this thing in this guy's shoulder. It was this guy in a suit and I never knew what it was. And then like way later on, I saw it again and it was a movie called How to Get Ahead in Broadcasting. And it was actually a comedy.
How to Get Ahead.
But when I was young, I saw this and I thought like this practical effects makeup and everything was so rad. And I thought like, whoa, this is fucked up. Like, this is scary. Speaking of Sam Raimi and practical effects and just all of this fucking movie talk, you ever see The Dark Man or Dark Man 2, Die Dark Man Die?
No, I haven't.
Oh, dude, cameos by classic Sam Raimi characters, but that's like always. But yeah, dude, the Dark Man movies are some of the earliest comic book films, and they're different than how they make comic book movies now. But great practical makeup effects. I would definitely recommend the first two Dark Man movies. Fucking awesome. Liam Neeson's Dark Man, like in the main character. Before he was getting his daughter back when she was taken. That's my Liam Neeson.
Be warned.
Pretty good.
It's not fucking good.
Could be Liam Neeson.
I have a particular set of skills. He almost has a Sean Connery thing going. Was he fucking British or what?
He's not from the U.S.
Nah, he better not be. That fucking dialect of his.
Yeah, it's crazy how, like, when you're a kid, you could see something like that and. I don't want to say traumatized, but definitely
no. But it sticks with you like that's visceral. That's whoa. I couldn't imagine someone could a head could grow out of their shoulder, and it you know practical effects look so real. I was my whole family talks about this all the time, but I was obsessed with a VHS tape of Michael Jackson's Thriller that I had, and I used to watch it. I used to watch it over and over and over again. And get scared because the effects and the makeup and everything were so realistic and so scary. The werewolf transformation, the zombie makeup and everything was like, it fucked me up as a kid. And yeah, I don't want to say like traumatizing, but fascinated me to where I liked being scared by it. So I'd watch it, get scared, turn it off. And then I would, you know, 10 minutes later come back, you know, watch it from where I stopped it. You know, it would take me all day.
What is left of
take me all day just to get through it. But I know that's where like the zombie fascination probably came from, and for sure that love of horror and just the monster makeup inside of it. I've always had a thing for it.
Yeah, I remember when I was really young, I was grounded and like I couldn't watch TV. I did something really bad. I can't remember what.
Fuck, you probably like burned a hole in the carpet or something bad. Something. Terrible.
I think I like hit somebody at school or something like that.
Yeah.
I was like,
you probably
I was
kissed a girl at school and the teacher and, saw and you were all busted.
So I was grounded, you know, you can't watch TV of course, but I snuck out in like the middle of the night to watch some TV. And I opened the
you were addicted.
The little TV doors and the Crypt Keeper was on.
Oh, Showtime.
And he does that thing where like he talks to you like Dora the Explorer, like talking to you specifically.
Yeah. Hello, kitty! Well, hold on, I can do a better one.
Yeah, he literally said, like, hello, kitty.
Hello, kitties! A ghoulish shape before I...
Yeah, I got that's all I got.
It was like an 8-year-old. I ran out of it and left it on all night. I got caught. Okay.
You thought he was calling you a kitty, and you were like, holy shit, the Crypt Keeper's fucking talking to me, he knows I'm up late.
I didn't know it, I just opened it, and I'm like, oh, what the fuck?
Dude, shit like that, yeah, I don't know. Weird memories of TV scaring me. It was weird when I was a kid, though, because, yeah, there was nothing, I don't know. Rocco talks about games scaring him. I guess games, nothing in, like, Super Mario Brothers or my NES games, like, ever scared me the way. Rocco describes, like, the eel in Super Mario 64. World,
yeah,
like,
Super
freaking
Mario
him out. Like, he hated it as a kid.
Dude, I loved it. I was always trying to figure out how to get, like, behind it or whatever.
Yeah.
Like, the area.
But, I don't know. I definitely have that thing where movies scared me, but never, like, for a while, their music scared me. Like, there was probably a point where I thought, like, Marilyn Manson does weird shit, and it's really scary. Like, I didn't really get it, and then I came around at some point.
Yeah, dude, I remember on Napster, there was a... Like, one of the 80 things that were on Napster at the time, there's, like, a Pokemon, where, like, Pikachu got killed by a grizzly bear.
Ooh, don't look at that. It's scary.
Dude, that... When I was a kid, yeah, I ran out of the room again. Just, like, that playing, I was like, oh, my God.
I bet you I'm gonna bring up something right now that I watched when I was, like, in my 20s, and I was like, hey, whoever made this is pretty creative. But I bet you that I'm gonna name this thing, and there's gonna be kids or younger audience members right now watching going, like, oh, fuck. But did Salad Fingers freak you out?
No, dude. I was on a... I'm an animator, so I was on Newgrounds when the time those started coming out. I thought they were stupid.
You were into it.
No, I hated them.
You hated them?
I was scared. I just thought they were dumb.
Yeah, I used to like make fun of it and be, well, I used to, I think, get, like, this is so fucking stupid. Why is it so popular? Like, I used to get jealous of how fucking big it was.
Yeah, I didn't understand why.
Even though I'm not an animator, I was just like, I can appreciate that that thing blew up, but. Yeah, I remember someone showing it to me and being like, this is kind of fucking, like, lame. But I'm sure that scared fucking kids.
Yeah, I remember, as far as songs that kind of freaking out, there's an ending to, like, a Disturbed song where, like, the singer just starts talking to, like, his, like, mom's hitting him or something like that.
Oh, my God. Yeah, and he's don't literally, listen to like, Korn. Like,
he's like, no, don't do it again. He's like, it's like a full minute of him just, like, screaming and getting beat. Oh. I didn't understand that when I was a kid.
You're like, I don't like this. This guy can't differentiate this from reality.
I think it's the end of the song that goes like, wah. Yeah, it's just that, the end of that song.
Can you give me your best? I think that's a way to go out, Kev. Because now here, we went super overtime because I'm just feeling like it. But maybe me and you, we give our best three, top three. Disturbed. I'm clearing my throat all over. I'll let you go first. Go ahead.
You want me to list songs, or you want me to like do
No, I want you. I want you to give me your best. Well, I'll go first. Repeat after me. Give me your best. Yeah. Ooh, wah! Okay, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. I'm gonna take my second one here.
I'm gonna take my second
one in the mic, and I'm gonna put a little bit of depth. And I'm gonna just a little bit of distortion. Just wanna get that. Hold on. I know
technically I'm adding electronics in here you don't have at your disposal right now.
Yeah, but you can let me use them.
Alright. Oh, that's true, Kev. I could do that for you. Okay, I didn't mean to do that.
Alright, well now I fucked it all up. All right, I'm gonna take
One,
it acapella.
Two,
I'm gonna go.
Freddy's come for what?
I'm gonna go. Yeah. Ooh, wah! Okay, that's by number two. Let's hear your number two. Go ahead.
Ooh, wah! All right.
Oh, that was awful.
That was a little. Well,
that's why it was a two out of three. Okay. Now I'm gonna take just a little bit of depth and a little bit of too much reverb. Just a little bit of reverb right there. Just a little reverb is not a lot. I do want that distortion back. I just want a little bit of distortion. It's too much distortion. Okay, a little bit of distortion right there, freeze. Okay, it's right there, it's perfect. I'm not gonna get, you know, hog the mic. I'm gonna get off of it a bit.
Okay, you ready?
I'm ready.
Here we go. This is my third attempt. Can you count me, Kevin? Can you count me down from seven, please?
17?
No, seven. Can I get a good old gaming cult podcast? Jake Innes shouts out moment. Did you
seven,
count
six,
me down from
five,
seven?
Five, four, three, two, one, go.
Okay.
All right, that was pretty good. That's pretty good. Right. But you know what?
All right, you got a third.
I got
your third.
This one. There's no chance.
Let's hear
Ready?
It. Did he just pull out a fucking head and beat me at the fucking end? This cocksucker fucking pulled a head at the end. That's the end of the show, and that's... Wait a minute. We got a last word from New Golden. New Golden, I love you, New Golden.
Go, it's on.
Hey, you got the last word?
Okay.
The last call?
Shout out.
It's the end of the show. Do you have a comment?
Yeah, just really quick. I know you're part of those GCP boys. I'm wondering when we're going to get... the latest and newest episode, or if there's one on the way.
Oh, you know what? It's not my exclusive to give, but I have heard communication lines. I've heard crosstalk. that possibly some dates might be put in a calendar for upcoming recording of a GCP.
Oh yeah, that's all.
I've heard this that could be a possibility or not. Take it as you will. But that's right, the last word, New Golden. This is the end of my Slimeria RPG. Thank you for sticking with us. Say hallelujah and glory to the highest, Golden.
Hallelujah and glory to the highest.
Breath of fresh air!
That's what I love to hear. Good night, folks.
They say in 2012 a comet's coming for this planet. Comes to kill us when it kills us, man. I hope I'm playing mad. And it's the sadness that y'all mad against us. All by shit like Halo. Halo's lame and mad is great. That's why I play it every day. So through the game effect, they made it back in 1988. And 24 years later, still the greatest ever made. So thank you, EA, for giving us this game. To Lord Madden in the skybox, to whom I praise.
Madden's back again here, 2012. Put those other 23 shitty games on the shelf. We know every damn year this game comes out. But this year's the best. No question, no doubt, Madden's back again in 2012. All you 2011 fans can burn in hell. Maya said 2012 is the end of the earth. So take me away, I got my 60 bucks.
Who's got more $50 bills than me? Bullshit, you know he really doesn't. That's a load of shit. I've got the most, put it on toast. Spread it around, I sell games coast to coast. I travel the same on all four wheels. I don't ride on airplanes, I eat my meals. Turducken is a big old turkey on a plate. Stuffed inside a duck, stuffed inside a Great Lake. Oh man, that's the size of my waistband. Come on inside my big ass RV minivan. I got a full size bathtub. You know I don't get paid in cash, I get paid in cold cuz. I'm a record beater, I'm a closet eater. I ain't no leaderboard, high score, fucking cheater. My game's the best, that's a fucking fact. And if your dick starts itching, spray it with Tenactin.
Welcome back to class, and when you teach it, it's time to school you new. Besides this badass new features you can sprint this year. You know what I'm saying?
Got some throwing animation?
What's this new game I'm playing? Kick off from 35, cause that's the big deal. Now players get concussions, whoa, shit just got real. That's all the new features, that's all they got. Better than ever!
Madden's back again, year 2012. Put those other 23 shitty games on the shelf. We know every damn year this game comes out. But this is the best, no question, no doubt. Madden's back again, year 2012. All you 2011 fans can't burn it now. We didn't do a song last year because we knew what was coming.
And maybe Madden's even got 13 in the oven!
Who knows?
That's right. We're talking John Madden football.
Fuck you, Naughty
Dog! Game gets better every year. What games you looking forward to this fall? Uncharted.
Fuck you, Atlas.
Batman.
Fuck you, Software Tool Works.
Nathan Drake can suck Batman's dick.
Suck on that shit.
Fuck Tiger Woods.
Chris Collins.
Fuck golf. How many of these games do they expect me to buy?
Go off with your pack of smokes and
fuck
go fuck yourself.
Damn.
Is there anyone jacking off to this right now?
Atomic penetration, rapid fire through your skull. Shot it, oh, we're taking it back to the days of trying to lose control. That's why we need a blaze of fire racing through my bones. Oh shit, I'm feeling it. Way too shit, how to make a hater disappear. Take shit where it ain't never been. Fuck what you thought, could not comprehend this shit. If I fist your brain with a 10, 9, 8, 7, triple 6, 5, 4, 2, 3, 1, 11, quick like this dog, not aware on your outdoor. And a picture big enough to fit what we dig up from the core. Till for the day, forgot ever was militant march off this war. Yeah. it while we spray. Cryonic hardened bullets all loaded with toxic waste. That is the deal if you don't feel it, don't wanna know when in my zone. That shit is dead, can't nobody get with that sick and style tone. Jack your bitch, slap it, pussy, block it, clones. Jack your setting off in the bombs inside your dome. Give it up, bitch, you know this is it, get with this again, left because it's on. Jack your.
Six million ways to die.
Oh, fuck.